The views expressed on the previous programs are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and do not reflect those of the Beasley Broadcast Group, its staff, advertisers, or agencies.
The biggest names.
The Glam are going crazy already, baby.
You're listening to Sports Radio 560 WQAM.
Nobody's got money. We're in a depression, but boy, don't stop the people from going out there and schlepping and shopping and smarting and whatever they're doing. And schmitten.
Yes.
560 WQAM presents The Neil Rogers Show. To talk to Neil, dial 570-560 in Dade and Rushley in other counties. Call toll-free 877-785-NEIL or pound 560 on your AT&T and Verizon wireless phones. The opinions expressed by Neil, his guests, or his callers do not represent those of WQAM management, staff, or sponsors. Now, The Neil Rogers Show on 560 WQAM.
Buffalo blows, and so do the Bills.
Oh! Excuse me.
Hi, can I help you?
Hi, yeah. I just bought these, and I'd like to have them gift wrapped. Do you have Christmas wrapping?
Sure. 2 aisles over near the Christmas tree.
Two aisles. Oh, thank you very much. pardon me, is this Christmas wrapping?
That's right, fool. Check it out. Happy holiday, y'all. We hope it's merry, because you're going to be broke come January.
On second thought, I think I'll do my own Christmas wrapping.
Go ahead then, chump, and wrap your own. It ain't so easy when you do it at home, because we got the wrap, we got the ribbon, and you know we love money more than robbing givens. We got the wrap.
Thank you.
I didn't know that in Iraqi culture that throwing your shoe at somebody is one of the worst. I think about the only worst thing you can do to somebody is throw a bullet at them.
Well, guess again.
What?
Yeah, throwing a shoe. No, it's the shoe thing. I had heard that a long time ago.
55 points. What?
I had heard that before a while back.
You had heard that?
About the shoes, yeah. I forgot all about it, but yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, he ducked. And meanwhile, what's his name, stood there like a goofball. Maliki, he didn't notice that?
Yeah, if
they would have thrown him at him, they'd have had two strikes.
Right.
Maybe it was Iraqi bowling. Maybe that's what that was. Well, here it is, Monday the 15th. We're only 10 days before Christmas and only 6 days before Chinooka. And, oh, brother, let's get this time of the year over with already. Jesus, God. You know, I don't want to be a party peeper, but, my God, people acting crazy. Saturday, my good fortune, Paco's BlackBerry just died on Friday. It didn't completely die. The battery was fine. And it would turn on, the little red light come on, and it was on, but the screen went black. It died.
Well, it was a BlackBerry.
Yeah, that's right. Are you starting a racial crap again? So anyway, I had to go Saturday to the Eaton Center downtown, the big shopping center. Oh, luckily at Rogers Communications, where I had to get the new BlackBerry, there were only two people in front of me. But just getting to there, just going in and walking through Sears and go. I have never, ever in my life, ever. No, I take that back. I was in Amsterdam on Queen's Day one year. That was a bad mistake. The only good part about that is wall-to-wall young people, and you're walking, you know, you're squeezing through to try to get where you're going. Oops, excuse me. And, of course, you always pick and choose which people you're, like, walking up against, you know. Oops, excuse me. Can that be felt? You know, like that. But this was nowhere near as pleasurable as getting in the crowd at Queen's Day in Amsterdam. This was annoying. Just masses and masses of crazed goyim and Jews, and at least the Muslims I don't think were there.
Masses of asses?
Masses of asses, some of them wearing glasses. God, just crazy people, just shoving and pushing and yanking and twisting. And then, of course, we got something you don't have, and that is the day after Christmas, we got Boxing Day.
Oh! What's that?
When stores open like at 4 or 5 in the morning, and everybody lines up for hours, and you know, and then they knock the prices down and everything. This year, I would imagine, would be crazier than ever, because people are looking for the big bargoons, you know? Can you believe it is plus 10, it's 50 degrees here? Hey, that's for Castronova. Oh, I have a fake email from him. Here it is. If you're going to send me fake emails, at least get the name of the person right that you're faking, you know? That would be a good step in the right direction. This is from Paul Casanova. Not Castronova, Paul
right.
Casanova. Hi, Neil. Long time that I don't talk to you since last time I ran into you with the Sawgrass Mall. As you are aware, my ratings are in the dump. I was wondering when you're going to stand up to Joyce and do the show like it's always been. That way I can copy your format so my ratings can improve. Hope everything is well in Canada. Sincerely, Paul Casanova. We were just discussing before the show started today, although at least, you know, this is a lame attempt at a little bit of humor. Lame, very lame. But we're talking about the fact that there are so many lifeless a-holes out there.
I have
there.
No just, life.
Since we started the email thing, it's just been a real fly-opener. I can't believe... I always knew that there were a lot of people who fit that I have no life.
I have no life.
Including most of the callers. But the emails have opened up a whole new window to the world. God. And there's nothing you can do to chase them away. Even this morning, in my deleted files, there was one from not Nick Nolte again in the Philippines, wherever he's hanging out. And, of course, I didn't read it because you just delete the deleted files. You just get rid of them, they go away, and you don't see nothing when you're dealing with blocked. How is it that some people are so stupid they don't realize that they're blocked?
Well, for the same reason you blocked them in the first place.
Because they're morons. They're idiots. Yeah. They're lunatics. They're crazy people. And these are people always giving me lectures about how they have this wonderful life and I have no life and nobody likes me and
right.
all this other bullcrap.
You should this and you should that.
Yeah, that's right. For example, here's more, what is it, critiques and...
Complaints.
Complaints.
Complaints and critiques.
Neil@neilrogers.com. That's our email for all your critiques and complaints. Here's one on today. This is from Pippi. Or is it Pee-Pee? Oh, boy. Take it nice and slow. On today's poll, you should add the reason divorce or relationship breakup. I know a lot of people who ended up here to escape from bad marriages or bad relationships. Another reason to add Florida is Florida homestead laws. Over many years, I've met people who bankrupted their businesses up north and bought huge homes down here, put in the names of family members, as well as some doctors who put all their money in their home so as not to carry such malpractice insurance. Oh, boy. Yeah, let's add a couple hundred things to the pool. You want to put divorce on there?
Okay.
Go ahead. Put it on there. We're having a divorce from Chris, not by choice, but I've got a very interesting email about Jolly Joe Bell from the fake Jim Sarney. Anybody remember Jim Sarney?
No.
Remember Media Friday?
No.
That was on the Mad Dog Show, Media Friday. He would read Jim Sarney's column and Barry Jackass. Every Friday, they would both write about sports radio. And then, of course, Jim Sarney got canned at the Sun Sentinel. He was just the beginning of the paring down. Everybody's getting fired everywhere. Everybody. And we were just also before the show this morning wondering about the fact that all these companies are making these humongous cutbacks. What happened all of a sudden that everybody stopped making money at the same time? I mean, we're looking at our log here, and it's overloaded with spots. We got spots up the ass, which I think there's a clinical disease term for that. Spots up the ass. And of course, the Joe Rose Show, he's got more spots than airtime. I mean, it's just commercials all for 3 hours. And I'm sure Mad Dog, Mr. Mad Dog, is loaded with spots. We got the Dolphins, the 9-5 Dolphins. And by the way, you people from Buffalo, you ought to be ashamed of yourselves. Not bad enough that you live in a crappy city, but your team just chokes and gags. That was an early Christmas gift, or maybe a Hanukkah gift to the Jets yesterday. Am I right, Chris? They gave them a game.
Yep.
You see that? You see that moron put the ball on the ground there? Oh, here you go. Yeah. They got the lead. They made a miraculous comeback, the Bills. It looks like for sure they're going to win the game. And, oh, no, here, we don't want it. You take it. You take the ball and run into the end zone. You miserable J-E-T-S-U-C-K. God. And then, of course, the Patriots just kicked the snot out of the Raiders. It was 21-0 before the crowd even sat down in their seats. Well, here's one that came in over the weekend. Neil, since all other insiders have assumed fake names, why not a representation by the fake Jim Sarney? QAM is at it again, he says. I'm sure this is from across the street. Let's see. Joe Bell has an obsession with Anita Marks. Since she failed on 1400 The Fan, she's been banished to Baltimore where she lost her own show and is now the sidekick on some other show. Her contract runs out at the end of the football season and she'd like nothing more than to come back down to Florida. Anita Marks. Anybody ever hear of Anita Marks?
No, I know her brother Skid.
Mm-hmm. And Groucho. Take that and combine it with Joe's severe infatuation with her, and you can take it to the bank she's headed to QAM. Not to mention the fact that Joe's already had discussions with her. That probably means bye-bye to D.A. QAM puts Anita Marks on. You can pretty much count on SSQAM hitting the ice and going down. It's quite clear that Joe and Clarence's talent evaluation is going to drive that station into the ground. Is gonna? I think you're talking in the wrong tense. In addition, I heard you talk about Ken Malden being out. If the budget is off, how are they going to afford a new host? Something is very shady in Bellland, it says here. In Bellland. Meanwhile, over at 790, changes are coming, too. Don't have your heart set on them going syndicated during the day. My heart isn't set on anything. I don't care what they do. I have no interest. It's just that when some crap comes along, we pass it along. Makes no difference to me. I hear that they'll go syndicated at night, not during the day. Think you got some bad info. Half of the Dos Amigos will be done, and the other half will be moved to another show. Kevin Rogers will be out. Thank God for that. Maybe him and D.A. can go back to Kansas City together, it says. Time to get back to picking horses with Defo at the track. Should I wear my blue or my brown members-only jacket? Signed, the fake Jim Sarney. Pudgy Jim Sarney. Anybody remember Jim Sarney?
No.
Anybody know Anita Mark?
No.
Anybody believe any of this crap about Joe Bell?
Yeah.
Sure. Like George always says, that's the one thing I got to hand to you. You signed that sports bar with a microphone thing way back in the beginning. Mm-hmm. You got it pegged right. If Joe and Clarence like it, it's going to do two things. It's going to suck and it's going to fail. But we don't want to talk about that during the holidays. Let's put a
That's right.
Right. Let's put on a happy face.
Let's ring
like
some
Fat
bells.
Fat Chris is going to do, even though he's going to be out pretty soon on our show. Put on a happy face, Fatso.
Will do.
When's that going to happen? Sure, it's not the,
I'll
not
let
the
you know.
One you got. Huh?
I said I'll let you know when I decide to do that happy face.
Oh, here you go. Here's Barry Jackass with a whole bunch of Beasley bought back a whole bunch of its stock and yada, yada, yada. And what does that mean? Oh, I don't really care about that. Sorry, Barry. No interest. Boring. Hasidic girl molested by 59-year-old. Also sounds like a very boring story. Ari Ikovitz, a Hasidic Jew, molested some chick. Just to let you know, I have some tickets for you to give your listeners for the grand reopening of the Marlin Beach Hotel taking place this weekend. Signed, Leona Feldman. Right. Right. Boy, what crap. What swill, man. Oh, yeah, and here's deleted people coming back, yeah. Deleted people. Deluded and deleted. I'm just checking it out. Now, what was I looking for? The poll. How did you end up in South Florida? 525 votes. That's amazing. You know what? My parents moved me here, 141. They should be horsewhipped. They should be buggy whipped for that. Parents that bring their kids to South Florida. Born here, 116. Job, 103. That was me. Job, 103. You ever listen to that?
No.
Neither did anybody else. I escaped South Florida, 45. I'm not in South Florida, 43. College, 24. Drafted by the Dolphins, 14. Right. Osama sent me here for flying lessons, 11. Banana boat, 10. Retirement, 9. Fled from Cuba, 6. My Mexican brother told me about the great benefits, 6. And divorce, none yet. We had a divorce on there because according to that one emailer. Oh, yeah, everybody and their brother came here because of divorce, a nasty relationship. And so far, it's got the big none. But what do we know? We don't know how to write.
Right.
We know nothing. We know nothing and we're proud of it. We're dumb. We're stupid.
The Sports Leader. No portion of this program may be reproduced without the express written permission of WQAM, Incorporated.
Buffalo Bites.
Oh! Flintstones, meet the Flintstones. They're the modern storage family.
Fred, why are you holding your head? Are you sick?
No, Wilma. It's Barney. I think he's got the hots for me.
It's psychological.
I think you need a checkup from the neck up, Rubble.
Somebody tell me what's happening. I'm confused.
Your husband's become a Weirdosaurus, Betty.
There's an inseparable bond that binds us together.
Why don't you just shut up and move to San Francisco?
You might as well get along, because you're going to have to sleep together.
When I go to bed, it's just me and Smith and Wesson.
Wilma will spend the night with me, and you'll stay with Fred, Barney.
What?
You've got a better idea?
Oh, great. Well, two can play that game, Wilma. Come on, Rubble. Let's go watch some gladiator movies.
Looks like we're going to be bunkmates, Fred.
When you're with the Flintstones, you'll have a gay old time.
Yeah, you got a problem with that, punk?
You fairy. 10:19 at 560 WQM. Let's take a look at the schedule. Let's see who's still working here. See, I had a really good idea, I thought, but it's pretty silly. When I saw these crazy people on Saturday in the shopping mall just going nuts, shoving each other and shuffling and hustling and hassling. And I thought to myself, wouldn't it be nice to, like, because everybody's broke this year, somebody come up with a novel idea, like recession cards.
Okay.
Instead of a gift, everybody send a recession card for Chanukah or Christmas or whatever. And it just says, best for the holiday season. Sorry, but everybody's broken, so no gift this year.
All right.
In other words, suspend the gift giving for 1 year because we're having a freaking depression, okay? Oh, no, we can't do that. Jesus would be unhappy about that, and Moses and Saul would be pretty pissed off, too. Don't you think that's a really novel idea?
Yep. I like it.
Yeah.
Everybody's getting a recession card this year.
That's right. Recession card meaning no gift. Sorry, can't afford it. Sorry. Sorry, mister. No God. But no, they're running out there. I'm going to tell you crazy goyim something, man. Every year we got to put up with this crap. Every stinking year, running around, acting like crazy people. Hey. Oh, I got to get some wrapping paper. And this one chick, she's holding this big roll of wrapping paper like a weapon.
Yeah.
Like a freaking gladiator, yeah. Oh, and by the way, the concert was on again over the weekend on whatever channel it was.
Mm-hmm.
The Hannah Montana concert with the Jonas Brothers. You can't complain about their music, the Jonas Brothers, because they don't write any and they don't sing any. They just make a lot of a lot of sounds. Yeah, that's it. Kind of like our audience. Like that.
All right.
So I'm off of them. Thanks for the book anyway, Jolly Joe, and we don't want Anita Mark on this station. She nobody ever heard of her. They already tried the thing with the sports babe. That worked out pretty good, didn't it? She came on the very first night. Well, I don't know anything about South Florida sports teams. Can anybody enlighten me? What's going on here? That was good. Colombian Julio says, I don't know what's worse, the calling of the game by Jimmy Syphilis or the comments of the big silly dog. Best regards, Colombian Julio. The worst play-by-play calling. WORSE. I just read them, okay? I don't write them, I just read them. Pass him along, Neil at neilrogers.com, and believe you me, anything this between now and the end of the year is going to be really cherished. Will really be valuable, even if it's caca, because,
caca.
This year, more than any year I've ever seen in my life, between about starting last Monday, and I'm sure through the end of the year, grim and slim. These people are busy. I'm busy. They're really busy. God. Here's one from Cal who says, just in case the topic comes up for discussion, the new movie version of The Day the Earth Stood Still. Just saw the movie and it really sucked.
Oh, yeah.
What, you liked it?
No, I saw it over the weekend. It sucked like the vacuum of space.
Just another excuse for computer-generated special effects.
Not even.
Incredibly bad script, really bad acting, especially Will Smith's kid who was just thrown in for name value.
Amen.
Keanu Reeves acts like a robot. Okay, he's supposed to be playing an alien, but he acts like a robot.
Yep.
Hey, Keanu.
You fairy.
He's from Toronto, eh? And Kathy Bates was even worse.
Yep.
Now, what was the movie she was in that you were raving about?
I can't remember. The one that about the late night. I think it's called Late Night.
Oh, that one. Well, that was a TV, made-for-TV movie.
Sort of. Nevertheless.
Nowhere near as good as the original 51 version. Tell everybody, save your money. Don't see it unless you get a bootleg from the Internet.
Amen. I want to echo that person's sentiments and then increase the volume a lot.
The day the earth... Oh, increase the volume?
Yeah. The day the earth stood still blows.
Blows chunks.
Wow.
Suck donkeys.
Hmm.
Ugh.
Yuck.
And I had high hopes. And by the way, if you're expecting more action than the original, forget about it.
The Dow's down 91 points. I like my idea of a no. I don't know how you'd say it. I mean, I'm not phrasing it right, but I think I'm giving you the general idea.
How about this? A best wishes card. You give people your best wishes. And
I send you my best wishes.
Right,
everybody's broke, including me. We can't afford any gifts this year, but you should all understand that. I don't expect anything from you, and you're not getting nothing from me. That would be nice. David says, did the shows of the people that went to see GW get checked? Oh, the shoes, like when we fly. If not, maybe now when somebody visits the White House, they'll have to take their shoes off. Well, if it's good enough for the Buddhist, it's good enough for the Goyim. Still enjoy both you and George since 1985. Happy holidays to all, says David. Thanks, David. Sei gesund. Here's another David in Flossmoor. Hope everything is well. Tell all those people who critique and criticize you to kiss your ass. Kiss my ass, okay? Kiss my big, fat, smelly ass. There you go, David. They're all losers in chronics. They suck. Keep up the good work, and Dan LeBastard blows. He's the absolute worst. Thanks for dealing with these losers. You make my day fly by. Well, thanks, old buddy, David in Flossmoor. I don't floss. Once in a while, I'll get, if I'm sitting there watching TV and I'm bored or whatever, and I got a thing of dental floss on the coffee table to kind of inspire me to go ahead and do it. I just don't do it.
I know either.
You're supposed to.
I
what?
Don't, me either.
Anybody out there floss your teeth? Like more than once a month or once every 6 months? Every time I get my teeth cleaned, the hygienist, she's really great. And she gives me another little thing of dental floss. I probably got a collection of them. I could start collecting them like stamps.
Learn how to do macrame, make stuff out of
it. Get me a floss album. Or maybe it'd be a nice Christmas gift. Here's some dental floss. Here's a health-oriented gift. Here's a little thing of a gob of dental floss. Here's one from somebody, Justin. He says, Florida really is a backward state. If you go on the Sun Sentinel website, the leading story is titled Gun Sales Surge at Shops with Fears Obama Will Ban Them. That's a story from like 100 years ago. Remember that right after the election?
Yep.
Inside the article, they got great quotes from stupid-ass Floridians such as Mike, who says, Obama's a gun-grabbing liberal, and that's all there is to it. As if this article didn't say it all right. Right next to the above headline, there's an article titled, Man Drops Gun Waiting in Line Shoots Woman.
That's not
nice going, Justin.
It.
Leo says, I was in Chicago last week, turned on the TV, and there was the big A-hole on national TV. He looks like Dracula or Cuban Joe Rose with a big head and black shoe polish hair. Also, I seen Zach a couple of weeks ago, and he lost 50 pounds. He's got 200 to go. What a fat pig, says Leo. Who's the first person he's talking about? The big A on national TV.
No idea.
No idea.
Huh. And he's calling Zach a fat pig. We'd like to see what you look like, Leo. Probably tipping about 800 pounds, you slob.
Biggest
you
name.
Big turd.
This is Neil
he's
Rogers.
He's got a good point, though.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The fourth league.
The biggest names. The best talent. It's the Mad Dog, Jim Mandich. Afternoons, 4 to 7. Sports Radio 560 QAM. The sports leader.
Run to the mall, go spend it all. Oh, it's quite oak, you're going broke. Run to the mall, go spend it all. Oh, it's quite oak, you're going broke. Let's fight the stinking traffic. The mobs of people are quite horrific. Let's find a parking space here, although the chances are quite terrific. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Run to the mall, go spend it all. Oh, it's quite oak, you're going broke. Run to the mall, schmuck, spend it all. Oh, it's quite oak, you're going broke, schmuck.
10:31 at 560 WQAM. There he is again, peeing on our parade. Next thing you know, he'll be telling the kids like he does every year that there's no Santa Claus. No Santa Claus, no God, no BS. Your parents made all of these things up. Well, there's somebody way before them made them up, and they just keep repeating the same crap. Oh, put your stocking out now. Put your stocking out, and Santa will stuff it. I'd hate to think what he's going to put in it. Kimbo says, that can't be our Kimbo, can it?
No.
Sure it can.
No.
How do you know that?
Because it's not. You mean Kimbo Camper?
Mm-hmm.
No.
How do you know that?
I would bet $1 million
against my penny.
Sure.
Anyway, it says, here's the card I give out. Times are tough, money's hard. Here's your effing Christmas card.
Our old.
Yeah, ancient. Well, so was Kimbo.
Mm-hmm.
That's another piece of evidence. No, he wouldn't dignify us with a reply. And I don't blame him, okay? Cigar store engine. Dullard. He's still on that thing. Oh, that's right. Let's take a look at the schedule today. See who's still here. Orlando 2-4, the big O.
Rock solid.
Mad Dog 4-7. Dolphins tonight 7-8. Oh boy. Then DA 8-11. 8-11.
So I was told that
yes,
Orlando was chosen as the station representative every week on ESPN. So that's who that email was talking about.
It says the big A.
I guess that's Al Zagari.
I see.
Or maybe they just
Al
are an idiot.
Zagari.
Orlando Al Zagari.
Al Zagari? Is he kin to, like, Joe Zagaki? Al Zagari?
I don't think so.
Hmm. So you're the one that got Leo's email. You figured it out.
What a sleuth.
No, someone sent me the message.
Sent you the message saying what?
That Orlando was chosen every week to represent the station on ESPN.
I have three words to say in reply to that.
Oh, my God.
Okay, Brandon sends me this. He says, I sent that Jewish story because the family of the molested girl sought rabbinical approval before going to the police, which I thought you would find funny. Yeah. It was kind of like, yeah, kind of like that funny, amusing. Anyways, on my work today, I was slipping through the stations, came across the first Bubba the Love Sponge promo. He said he was going to shake this bitch up. Thought I would let you know. Shake the bitch up, Bubba. But I guess he didn't hear the show. Didn't he debut this morning on whatever station he's on, 93 point something? One of those?
I don't know.
How come we haven't had any spy reports about Bubba the Love Sponge?
Good question.
Because he's going to shake this bitch up. Ah, blah, 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 blah. Yeah.
We'll start shaking.
Yeah, shake this. Rick in Deerfield says, just sitting here wrapping gifts. And remembered when I first started listening to you. A friend told me back about 1985 about a radical and funny talk show. Been listening ever since, but never had the balls to call. Best wishes to all, says Rick in Deerfield Beach. Well, happy Merry Christmas and happy whatever. All those things, Rick. To me, it's a pain in the ass. Because I don't celebrate Christmas. I certainly don't celebrate Chanukah. And, you know. And that makes me a bad guy. It makes me a party pooper. And I give plenty of gifts all year long. I'm a very generous guy. But I don't think we ought to have, like, one period of time when it's, like, mandatory. Either you give a bunch of gifts to everybody and their brother, or you're a bastard, you know?
Right. Well, if you have children, you're not allowed to opt out. Or that's like child abuse.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Hmm. Well, I got a real good answer for that. Don't have any kids.
Yeah, if you don't want to. See, the Jehovah's Witnesses do that. They don't celebrate, and they're like really militant about not celebrating it.
Really?
And their kids just grow up in a world of hurt. Boy, they're made fun of. They have to envy everybody else. You know, they just feel like crap around this time of year.
Hmm.
Well, they do.
How do you know that?
Because I've known lots of them. When I was growing up, I was like, oh, the little J-Dub kids, they're not getting anything. Their parents insist that nobody give them anything.
And there's a lot of adults not getting any, too, and that's another story.
Yeah, that's right. Well,
Christopher in Unionville, Connecticut says, the only good movie Kathy Bates ever made was Misery. Ever since then, her career's gone downhill. Thank God we can listen to you on the streaming. Connecticut radio sucks, says Chris in Unionville, Connecticut. Thanks, Chris. Now, you said that movie, she was in the TV movie.
Yes. It was a very good movie, and she did a very good job. I think it's called Late Night. Somebody wrote us an email.
Yeah.
Might have saved it.
Well, why would you doubt that? That was on Friday. You can't remember from Friday to Monday?
I can't remember from 5 minutes ago.
Oh. Senile.
Uh-huh.
This morning, he was bellyaching about this new studio setup they put together there, which is totally unsatisfactory.
Well, it's not done, so...
It's not finished.
Right.
It's kind of like that studio that Bob Vermouth built in Amsterdam, you know, and then he just left. He kind of left everything hanging. And the Dutch engineer over there wanted to, like, commit Harry Carey.
And it's not so much the new studio, but the new audio vault system is leaps and bounds behind the other one. In other words, the
I
old
see.
System was way better. As bad as it was way better than this.
Well, of course. Is there any doubt about that? That's the way they're going to do it?
That's progress.
Not slow, not fast, just half-fast. That's the Beasley effing way. Now, this one from fake Johnny Depp. Bonjour, Neil. I'm glad to see Bill Kamal is free and in America. I'll keep my kids in France where they'll be safe. No 7-Elevens here to get picked up at anyway. Au revoir. P.S. Play Dwayne Stomp for an old friend. I'll send you a pirate blow-up doll. No. Not the fake Johnny Depp. Don't get any requests on this show. Boy, it's going to be a long last. What do we got? Although, actually, I'm not on vacation until like the 28th or 9th, whatever that day is. 29th? 2 weeks from today.
Right.
Hey, that's my birthday.
Is it really? Well, happy birthday.
Well, thank you very much.
Happy birthday. Oh, and somebody else is sending me this thing. Beasley Broadcast Group suspends dividends in effort to conserve cash. I'm not interested. They get psychotic. They go crazy when anybody talks about their stock. So the last thing we need to start doing now is...
I want to blow out my brains. And no wonder it dropped and said, then why did I buy BBGI?
Well, we got so many of those, you know, might as well make some use of them.
The late shift.
That's
the
it.
Late what?
The late shift.
Ever take a late shift?
No.
I took several early ones this morning. Wow.
Yeah.
Talk about being
one.
In the holiday mood. I was joicing and rejoicing and rejoicing. Wow,
yeah.
wow. Oh, yeah. Woo! Lots of rejoicing. Now I'm done. Now I'm all like at
yeah,
ease.
I'm not.
You know? You're not?
No, I think I might have
Joyce
to go back.
May go rejoice again just for the holidays. Because we're in the holiday spirit here at QAM. That's why a lot of people are getting fired. Isn't this very appropriate, by the way, that all these people are getting laid off and fired right at holiday time? Merry Christmas, and by the way,
you're fired.
Man. Yeah. Bastards. KC, not our KC, but some other KC guy in L.A., says, I'm listening to today's show, meaning Friday, from the archives. Just heard you mention you're unaware of anyone listening from L.A. I thought I'd drop you a quick note, let you know I'm a longtime listener from the mid-'80s, listening from Los Angeles for over 10 years now, since early 98. I listen every day, often play the archives as well, in case I missed anything on the live broadcast, as I'm either getting ready for work, commuting to work, actually working during the show. Technically, I'm listening from Simi Valley, just outside L.A., but I live in L.A. My office is about a mile from the Presidential Library and Simi Valley, the Reagan Presidential Library, as a point of reference. You care where his office is?
No.
You care about Ronnie Reagan? No.
No.
I mean, not that we want to sound insensitive. We're delighted that you're listening.
Wow, that's really interesting.
No, he was a nice guy. Okay, a little bit boring, but a nice guy. Christ, send him a gift.
The best talent. This is Neil Rogers.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports lead.
The biggest names.
The best talent.
It's the DA Show.
Weeknights from 8 to 11.
Here on
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
Buffalo blows, and so do the Bills. Oh!
At 560 WQAM. Happy Monday to you, December 15th. It's one of the few days between now and January 2nd that's not a holiday. You got your Christmas and Hanukkah and Boxing Day and New Year's Day and all of these things. And then we get it over with, and then we get back to the drudgery of like all those just plain days, you know? Who wants a plain day? It's like plain Jane. Although she was very attractive.
Who? Plain Jane?
No. Just, I'm just bringing the attractive thing up again since you got so worked up about that
on
Friday.
Right, that's what I do. Look, just because you don't know the meaning of the words, don't mean
all right,
that,
fine.
That
okay. Joey, what's his name? What's the group? See, I already forgot.
The Jonas Brothers?
Jonas. I'm serious, I forgot because I saw that concert again, and believe me, they can't sing at all.
Should have turned the volume down and played a
Joey
record.
Jonas is not attractive. He's hot. Okay? Does that make you feel better?
No.
Oh, makes me feel better.
Okay.
Anyway, I'm losing it. I'm totally out of. I told you between my birthday and the new year, every year I'm just in a fog.
Well, join the club,
Bubba. The reason we're not getting any spy reports, and thanks to Bob, he starts his new show. Oh, the knob guy is out there, the knob polisher.
Well, wait. I'll play some music. I'll fill for you if you want to go see him.
He's twisting it.
Mm-hmm.
Extra hard too, by the way. Bubba starts his what?
Nothing.
He's twisting my knob very hard.
Sure, it's not the first time.
Bob starts his new show on January 5th from 9 to noon on 96.1 K-Rock in Fort Myers. 9 to noon? I thought his show was on 6 to 10 a.m., at least here anyway. Well, maybe they're going to tape it. Who the hell knows what the story is? So thanks, Bob, in Fort Myers. See, and then Dayton Broward, they don't know from nothing, but a guy in Fort Myers, he, you know, he takes the time to send us the Emmys to give us the report. 6 to 10 a.m. on one of those awful cock stations. 93.1, 103 point, whatever the hell it is. Bubba! Bubba Love Sponge. If you're a Tampa redneck kind of guy, you'll love that show, I'm sure. Because that's Bubba. Never heard him, though. He might be great. I bet you he's the best. Let's see. Here's one that says, saw the movie as well and concur with your synopsis. It blows. Question, though, did you see the trailer for 2012?
Yeah, it's going to blow, too.
Well, says, what do you think? George says he thinks it's going to blow.
It's going to be pretty plotless, you know, in other
words.
Will
they stay true to the concept of Nibiru?
What?
Nibiru.
I don't know. I just got a book somebody gave me for my birthday, but I haven't read it yet, about 2012.
Will they stay true to the concept of Nibiru? You don't know what that means?
No, not yet.
Google it, Fatso.
Spell it again.
Nibiru. The concept of Nibiru. You guys are the best. I think you found a winner with this format. Merry whatever, Chris and Pembroke Pines. Thanks, Chris. I agree. The calls blow. All these people, oh, we like the funny phone calls. There aren't any funny phone calls, okay? They're just three or four morons. And that's it. And then, like I you know, these people wanted me to continue going back the same old stuff again. You know, once in a while I throw one on there just for variety. There aren't any coming in right now, and there probably won't be all this week or next week or the week after that. It's the holidays, baby. Everybody's running around like crazy people because they're compelled. The Spirit of Christ compels them to go out there and shop until they drop. What a stupid bunch of crap. Oh, no, it's a good peace on earth. Yeah, well, go get a good peace. Crying out loud. Oh, here's one from J.P. Lewis, man. It says, man, do I suck. I stink like fresh crap. My life is really great, making millions. I really have no idea what the hell I'm doing on the field. The Dolphins need a backup. I think I'll be relocating soon. Yeah, J.P. Lewis, man. When your name is Lewis, man, that means you're going to lose. He really gave that game away. It was shades of Sage Rosenfields, the way he put that ball on the ground. It was like he set it down. Did you see that play, Chris?
Not really. I just saw the highlight for half a second.
That's what I mean. I'm not talking about live. Yeah. Did you see the clip of it?
Yeah, I didn't get to see it very well.
It was kind of like he just handed them the ball and said, here, run it on in, and good luck to you in the playoffs, like that, you know. And those stinking, rotten, smelly Jets fans are, oh, we kicked their ass. Yeah, right. You ought to get on your knees and thank God that you got that win yesterday.
So according to these theories of Sumerian cosmology...
I beg your pardon?
Nibiru was
what
the
12th... What kind of caca are you guys talking about?
Nibiru was the 12th member in the solar system family of planets, which includes 10 planets, the sun, and the moon. Its catastrophic collision with Tiamat, a planet that was between Mars and Jupiter, would have formed the planet Earth, the asteroid belt, and the moon. So it's a theory of how the Earth... asteroid belt and the moon came together, or were formed. You want to read it one more time?
I feel better now.
No, I'm going. You know, funny, you were talking about missing a spot shaving.
Yes.
And I realized that my chin, I shaved very poorly this morning. I don't know why.
It'll just drive you nuts, because now you'll be, like, rubbing it.
Oh, I don't want to rub it.
Rub it raw.
But the advantage I have over you is I can run in the next break. run into the bat room and pick up my
joint. Well, I got this little thing here.
That's not going to cut it.
It doesn't cut it.
What is that?
It's one of those little, it's like a trimmer.
Yeah, like a tree trimmer. Like a Hanukkah bush
trimmer.
Yes,
very much.
Uh-huh.
Like that, but it doesn't shave very close, no.
Well, I'll be damned. Mark says, screw the callers. Attaboy, Mark. Neil, my sister told me about your radio show back in the 70s when we were both in high school. She listened to it because she liked your guests, and the callers, she said, were hysterical. My sister was always into astrology. She's a crazy person, and she especially loved when you had Mickey Dane on. Oh, who's with a B? What's in your hair? Who's with a B? I listened once or twice, and I just didn't get it, so instead of listening to something I didn't care for, I turned it off. What a concept. I turned it back on, and after my sister told me you changed your format, no longer had boring guests and old ladies as callers asking about their colostomy bags. I haven't missed many shows since then. I bought all your best of CDs, anything else you would tout, restaurants, vendors, and the like. Now you have a show with basically no callers, a talk show with no callers. I don't think anybody could pull it off with all the restrictions QAM and the a-hole lawyers and Joyce have burdened you with, but then the only callers are Darone and Blind Mike and the I'm Your Friend guy and the quarter slot guy. I say screw the callers. The email is just fine. If you can pick and choose and block whomever you want, unlike the phones where you have little ability to filter all the crap except through the delay. I've only called once or twice in 20 years because I didn't feel I could contribute to the show. Neither do these guys. They contribute nothing except angst and agita. I only hope that when you decide to retire, you do it on your own terms. Also hope that one day George gets his own show. Just stop arguing with the religious crazy nuts, he says. I mean, I guess he's talking about you. Do you argue with the crazy religious nuts?
As often as I can. I'm not going
to
stop
Even
that.
When you lose, they just want to hear their voice on the radio, tape and listen to it later in their bedroom while they blank. While they blank. One can only begin to imagine what they're blanking and where they're blanking. That's right. Thanks, Mark. Excellent butt-sucking email. I like it. We need a lot more like that as opposed to,
bah, bah, you should do this. Bah, the poll should be that. Bah, bah.
I got to go shave. I mean, I did shave, but I don't like the way I shave my chin.
I know.
The hair on my chinny chin chin.
It'll drive you nuts.
Where did that come from, the hair on his chinny chin chin? What
the three pigs. Not by the hairs
it?
On the three pigs and the wolf and the blow my house down and
Zach
all that.
Zach and Beast and Fat Chris?
That's right.
Oh, yes, speaking of Fat, guess who I saw? I didn't see it live, but I saw a clip of him interviewing Chad Pennington after the game yesterday. Let me give you a clue. The Humper. I guess he must have been doing it for ESPN, huh? What do you think, Fatso?
I would assume.
You see him?
I did not know.
You know what he looked like?
Yeah, I know what he looks like.
Hank. He looked just like Hank. Attaboy, Humper. Hang in there, man. So that I guess he got to cover the home game, although he says he doesn't get to spend too much time in South Florida. That's why he's so happy, I guess. He seemed pretty happy that we had that dinner. Oh, no. Oh, the Beast sends me a picture of Anita Mark dressed up in a dolphin getup. Oh, my God. I'm going to forward this to you.
Please.
I will. Let's see. Forward. Here we go. Forward to George. This is Joe Bell's crush.
No, no.
Well, that's what that email said.
That's
I don't
what that
know
email
about.
Said. You know, we don't know if it's
I beg
true.
Your pardon?
We don't know if that's true.
Are you sticking up for Jolly Joe again?
I'm just saying.
You
people can say anything.
Clown.
Yeah, that's it.
Didn't he get through telling you what a great job you do and how much he admires you and wishes he could be just like you?
Yes. The fake
and
Joe Bell
said
that.
3%
right.
Raise. I think the 3% raise is being recalled because of the situation.
Mm-hmm.
The Dow's down 94 points. It just kind of sat right there. Oh, and by the way, bad news for you serious people. 14 cent.
Oh, my God.
Ooh. I think when we left on Friday, it was 15 cent, and now it's 14. If that thing cracks 14, if it finds itself a new bottom.
Rectum.
Oh, boy. Look out. You load 14 cent, and what do you get? Tennessee Ernie Ford, going to be on the show next week.
Good.
Might as well. Might as well drag his ass in there and prop him up where Chris used to sit. That would be a good idea. Our dead man of the week, sitting in the chair where Fat Chris used to sit. Yeah. Our dead board op. 1056 at QAM.
The biggest names, the best talent. You're listening to Sports Radio 560 WQAM. Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
This is the Neil Rogers Show. This is your brain. Any questions?
This is a test. For the next 60 seconds, this station will conduct a test of the emergency British broadcasting system. This is only a test.
American colonials have never really appreciated what we in the UK have done for you. We've given you everything from a system of government to Boy George. And what have you given us? Except for those stupid shows on the telly like Dynasty. And even there, you just gave us back Joan Collins we never really wanted to hear in the first place. So really, when it comes right down to it, we're not very happy with you at all. No, no, no.
This has been a test of the emergency British broadcasting system. In the event of an actual emergency, we still would have made time to serve you at least a cup of tea in perhaps lovely crumpet or scone.
No, no, don't like scones either.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, that's the one you like.
Yes, I requested that. Thank you.
And I like it, too. Well, I found it.
So.
I found it. Yes.
I see this picture. Rings a bell with me. I do believe this is someone who posed naked and that this particular picture is part of that pictorial from Playboy or something.
Yeah,
that
she
I
did.
See her ugly horse face.
So that's really Anita Mark?
Yes. And now am I going to have to find the naked pictures of her and send them to you?
No, I don't want to see naked pictures of Anita Mark. I want to see naked pictures of Joe Jonas. That would be a bonus. That was down 105 points. I don't want to see naked pictures of anybody. I'll be very honest with you. Naked pictures of guys to this old fag are much less stimulating than I'm sure than naked pictures of chicks to like straight guys.
Okay.
Naked is not, you know, I mean, unless it's somebody in the sack with you naked, that's a different story, or like sitting right next to you. But naked pictures, I don't know. Like guys that send me pictures of these big, phony, rubbery penises. Oh, Jesus. God. Not phony. Real. Ugh. Fooey. Donna in Pembroke Pines says, "Hey, Neil, happy holidays. We've been listening to you for over 20 years, and you are by far the best talent ever on radio." I agree with that. I'm no Bubba the Love Sponge, though. Bah, we're going to kick the bitch. Whatever Brandon said. Going to kick the bitch in the ass. Yeah, starting January 5. My wife and I were saying the other day, what's going to happen when Neil finally retires? We're dreading that inevitable day. I'm not. Maybe tomorrow would be a good day. Retire! On another note, we do like to hear the phone calls every once in a while because sometimes people actually have something to say. However, the emails are a better idea. Right? Good thinking, Donna. A better idea. A much, 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 much better idea than,
I'm your friend. I'm your friend. I'm really your friend. Hi, Ron. It's Doron. Ron.
And closing, you're the best ever, by the way. So you know you have an audience. You may be surprised to hear about the girls of Western High, ages 15 to 18, love you. We say this because we heard you don't have much of a woman audience according to the numbers. Please don't leave us anytime soon. Keep up the good work, Neil. Thanks, Donna. The girls of Western High, 15 to 18, love you. How do you like that?
That's great news.
Well. And we love them.
Right. You got a lot in common.
We love everybody who listens, who isn't a pain in the ass, who isn't a chronic complainer.
Wah, wah, wah.
We hate those people like poison. But keep listening and keep putting marking it down in those diaries. Oh, let's see. Oh, a piece of copy for next week. Can that be right?
It's a correction.
It's a correction of what? The date on this copy is April 17th. This is the all-time best.
I asked for a correction on that other piece of copy. Remember the address?
And they gave you 15th Street Fisheries, which is not this account, okay? The copy is for Miami Prime Grill with the correct address, but nevertheless. Oh, my God. Talk about starts April 7th, 2008.
Yeah, and the copy says, yeah, you're right. It says it's all about Miami Prime Grill.
Right. And it's got the correct address without
right.
700 different numbers in the address.
But at the top it says 15th Street Fisheries and all that stuff. I told you.
Is this from Andrew, the
idiot? Yeah, there is no bonehead bigger.
You're an idiot, Andrew. You're a moron. You're at the exactly the right place for you, baby. QAM sales.
The best part was when he came in here to bring that one back.
Yeah.
He seemed like he was, like, very mad that he had to bring it back over again and, like, you know, that it was yeah. returned to him the first
we
time.
We did something wrong.
Right. Simpleton. Moron. And I bet you Chris Jones found him.
Yep.
Probably out on a street
yep.
corner somewhere.
Likes him. Loves him.
So I went in and I redid my chin. The problem was that the razor I was using was finished and, you know, I don't have any more of that particular kind. I got some other new ones, like the three-track. What do you call that one? A Gillette with the triple...
Triple track? Three-track?
No, triple track my ass.
No way.
But anyway, that was the problem. So my chinny-chin-chin is now a little bit better. You're the one that put that in my mind. You planted that
That's
seed
right.
in my mind.
That's how I do.
How what a pain in the ass it is when you miss a spot shaving, and then later on you realize, oh, geez, I look like a clown more so than usual, you know?
I'm not worried about how it looks. It's just every time you touch that spot, it's like, ah, geez.
Oh, this is very bad. This is from 10:52 a.m. this morning. Mark it down. From somebody with no name. Oh, this is a chronic again. As Jim Morrison said, this is the end for QAM. Clearly, WQAM is the weakest link, is already teetering on the edge, and will not survive when Cheap Channel opens up their sports station with real promotion and a real signal. And where is Jicka, who promised to get back to you on Friday with the inside scoop? Well, we never got the copy of the memo from over there. We're slipping. We just don't have the sources
the poll,
that we used
right.
to have. What?
We don't have the poll we used to have. Or the connections.
We don't have the poll. We used to be able to pull it.
Mm-hmm.
Also, there are rumors that Cheap Channel fired the schlub who leaked that memo. By the way, why are they blowing out 93.9? They should blow out the Ethnic 103.5 or 94.9, which are much weaker and only have ratings at all because Arbitron unfairly skews toward Ethnics.
Yes.
No, they're not much weaker. They're all Class C FM. They're 100,000 watts. But as usual, the morons at Cheap Channel make the worst possible move. Well, this is somebody who can't make up their mind whether QM is the... We will not survive, but Cheap Channel makes the worst possible. That's why we do survive. Because the competition is even dumber than our management, which is almost impossible. But trust me when I tell you, anybody that would put Jimmy Syphilis on in the morning and they're talking about this great sports lineup they're going to have. Oh, my God. Jimmy Syphilis on FM. You'll be able to hear every lisp and every, mince. Get some mince pie for Christmas. Jimmy is selling it. He's having a closeout sale from that wine joint. Oh, you're unfair to Jimmy Syphilis, Neil. You're so nasty. Dear sir, I am Barrister Hillary Williams from Nigeria. Well, get lost, Hillary. Oh, yeah.
Come on now. You might want something.
These never stop coming in, man.
No, I know.
These never stop. Every man's fantasy job. Oh, this is like some guy peddling his business. Let me just say this right now, whether it's on the MySpace page, although we get nothing on there at all anymore. On the show MySpace, we get nothing. Except occasionally people, what's that thing, mobsters or whatever? That,
yeah.
What is that?
There are lots of games that you
yeah.
can play.
If you're trying to suck me into some game or promoting some crap, forget about it. Not going to happen. I just delete you.
Neil doesn't play that kind of game.
No. There are other games I like to play. Here's one that says, just saying hi again. How about people who were transferred due to their jobs? Job transfer. Doesn't it say job on there?
I think it does. I think it does.
Let me go back and look at the poll and see what it says. Job, 118, third place. Read the poll, okay, before you start.
Meh, meh, you made a mistake. You left one out. Meh, meh.
Oh, here's Dr. Al. Your gift to me would be to go away. The people who are blocked here, they don't realize, are you that stupid when I say, like a P.J. Barron. He's got two or three on here again, and he deleted. Let me just delete all those deleted ones again. Empty, delete, and they're gone. They're long gone. I don't read them. Although we'll keep you off the street and I guess give you something to do since a lot of you are trying to tell us
I have no
that
life.
Message. Over and over and over again. Josh Davis has found every man's fantasy job. He found a way to mix high horsepower, gorgeous girls and provocative poses. He sells sexy glamour shoots and he's trying to use our website or our thing here to promote. If you're interested in a job as production assistant, get in line. He's got a resume stacked 3 feet high. Well, good for you, Josh. Good luck to you. All the unemployed people are going to be sending,
I'm out of work. Give me a job, Neil. Give me a job.
Chris's job is open very soon. Of course, we're not going to be replacing him. We're replacing him with an empty chair with a dead man, with a dead body.
Right.
How about Jim Morrison in the dead? We can, I'm assuming
he's going to have the zombie of the day in there.
What?
We're going to have the zombie of the day. And
Elvira.
Okay.
635 votes on the poll. I wouldn't be surprised if we can make it like 850 today. On the 15th of December. Wouldn't that be quite a feather in your ass?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm talking about... You don't care about the poll. They know that by now.
Good.
You don't care. And I don't blame you. I wouldn't care about it either unless it's, you know... It's the staple. It's the centerpiece. It's like the maypole. What is the maypole? I remember in elementary school, we used to dance around the maypole.
Yeah, with the ribbons and everything. It's something that you do on May Day. It's a pagan ritual.
It's another pagan ritual? You mean like Christmas?
Celebrate spring, that kind of thing.
Oh, like Christmas.
Correct.
How did you end up in South Florida? 637 votes, only three in triple digits. Parents moved me here, 173. Born here, 141. My job, 118. See, it's on there. Fled from Cuba, only 7. And that's because the young Cubans, under the age of 100, they were born here. They're in category number 2. Fled here from Cuba, the old. They're listening to Radio Mambino. Not the Radio Mambino.
The best talent.
This is Neil Rogers.
Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
The biggest names. The best talent. It's the Big O. Orlando Alzugari. Afternoons 2 to 4. Sports Radio 560 QAM. The sports leader.
Oh, God.
The holiday season. Everyone loves Christmas carols. But until now, no one has ever written holiday songs about that other big holiday this time of year. That's right. I said, until now. Introducing Hanukkah Carols on CD.
Hanukkah is always right at Christmas. This ain't something new.
If you didn't know it, then you're not a Jew.
Hanukkah Carols on CD spins like a dreidel as it gives you hours and hours of holiday music to get you into the other spirit of the season.
On the 8th day of Hanukkah, my mother gave to me 8 pounds chopped liver, 7 slabs of corned beef, 6 potato latkes,
5 years of gills.
If you're tired of the old traditional songs of the holidays, here's a whole new tradition you'll get tired of almost before you know it.
You better buy gifts and get them on sale.
You know how we hate to pay retail.
Hanukkah is coming to town.
Hanukkah Carols on CD. It's the holiday collection you just can't pass over.
Okay, 1118 at 560 WQM. So when the new year comes, when we finally get all these holidays out of the way, all the radio cockeray is going to go down. All the big changes across the street. Sid the Kid is going back to New York, allegedly, so the rumor goes. Sedano's going in the morning, so the rumor goes. Midday, they're going 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. syndicated, so the rumor goes. And whatever else. Anita Mark's coming to QAM because Joe Bell's got the hotspur. Alleged. Bubba the Love Sponge starts on, what is it? Which one? 93.1?
Okay.
Anybody there? Hello?
No.
Hello?
I'm here, but I don't have those answers.
I'm just telling you, starting after the new year, a whole bunch of the other shoes are going to drop, not the ones in Iraq. Those dropped against the wall. Got to give the old bugger credit, man. He kind of juked and jived.
Should have just practiced, you know? Like,
didn't have to practice. So, he made all the right moves. Too bad he didn't do any during the 8 years he was in orbit.
No, I'm talking about the shoe guy. The shoe guy needed some target practice.
Practice makes perfect?
Right.
Here's one that says from last week. I'm going back to Thursday because the emails have dried up here already. It's not even close to noon yet. And already this morning. Well, you got to understand, it's the holidays, Neil, you heathen faggot. Oh, there's Blagojevich. Well, you know, he looks like Stan Major. He looks like a young Stan Major, who is also from Illinois, by the way. Since we were talking so much about Stan last week.
Yeah.
Blagojevich looks like Stan, especially the goy part. He really does. Wow. He looks just like Stan Major.
No, is that a toupee or just a really, really bad hair?
A really bad head of hair, I guess. I don't know. Or a really bad toupee. One or the other. It's bad. And if anybody knows about it, I wonder which doctor performed the surgery on his hairpiece, on his toupee. You asked, and so on the TV show Supernatural, it says, Dean is so obviously the bottom due to the way that he always bitches and complains like a bitch in every single episode. Dean is the bottom.
Okay.
Likewise, Sam is obviously the top because the way Sam always seems to take control of situations and fears no evil and tames Dean subserviently like a bitch. So take that, Josh Cordes. Hell yeah, Supernatural rule, says signed Gay.
Gay.
Hmm. Wow. It's a good show. You ever watch it? No, you wouldn't watch
Once.
It. Once. Why?
Because you told me to.
And?
And it was, whatever, weak, boring, was it
that
for
was
me?
Down 87.
Yeah, yeah,
it's
yeah.
not weak or boring. It's a good show. No items in this view on the email. This is, I'm going to be playing Christmas music all week.
Do it.
I don't mean regular Christmas music. I mean, you know, like the
irregular Christmas
yeah.
music?
Irregular, yeah. Because they got nothing. Well, we're busy. You don't understand. We're at the mall, Neil. We're at the mall. Send out some Hanukkah guilt to me and George. And Fatso
right.
here, too. Hanukkah guilt. Oh, my God. Isn't that sad?
By the way, I was just going to say...
Yes?
As I live in Hollywood and I see all the Hanukkah decorations everywhere, I don't
Do
think
you?
It's just the goyim that are part of the madness anymore.
I already said the people with their Hanukkah, too, but that's like such a small slice, man.
I think
that's
it
a small
used
slice.
To be, but anymore?
Anymore what?
I don't the think
Jews
anybody wants to be outdone.
Rabbits. You got us confused with the Muslims, man.
Yeah.
You got the wrong Semites. My Indian friend, my young Indian friend at... Woodbine showed up Saturday morning again. He's there usually mostly Saturday morning. And he's obsessed with the end machine on the Wheel of Fortune. Obsessed with it. I think in his spare time he'd like to take it home and do things with it. I'd like to take him home and do things with him, I'll tell you that. But anyway, he lost $3,500 in that machine Saturday morning before he finally either ran out
wow.
of cash or, you know, before he maxed out his cards for that day. Now, where does a punk like that get $3,500 to lose in a machine, man?
I don't know. Maybe
he's
stole
like,
it.
Like early 20s, you know.
Nice
much sugar daddy?
I beg your pardon?
A sugar daddy?
You think he's got a sugar daddy?
Never
There's
know.
This other big, ugly Indian guy that was hanging around with him, which I've never seen before. And then Sunday morning, the big, ugly Indian guy was there with some other good-looking Indian kid playing and losing his ass on another Wheel of Fortune machine. Should I draw the conclusion?
It's possible.
I mean, are Indian people, are there any Indian people? I would imagine when you got a billion people, there might be a few fruitcakes
right.
running around, you know? You think?
Right, even if it's just 1%, there's got to be a few.
Why would it only be 1%?
I said, even if.
Like Chinaman. Oh, look at this. Here's one from somebody. How about a poll edition? Came here on vacation and never left. Came here to meet someone, never left. Listener since the late 80s, haven't stopped listening since. Love George and Chris, too. We'll miss you, Chris. You were a great addition to the show. Always George and never tapes, says Steve from Boca.
Thanks
Steve.
Steve.
Thank you.
Who's got a strange picture. I can't even make out what it is. Got a picture. A tree and a head. I don't know what it is. Well, thanks anyway, Steve. I can't figure out what you're sending. Strange people. You want to add, came on vacation and never left?
Sure,
I really don't
sense.
Care.
Sure.
This pull blows. Have we got tomorrow's pull on her yet? No, nothing to switch. Huh. Maybe Eric didn't like my pull.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Well, he didn't put the additional one, the other one on there. Maybe I'll make one about the holidays. Nah, we don't want to do that. That would be too sour. Everybody wants to be in a happy mood, baby. It's the holidays. It's Chanukah. It's Christmas. It's the birth of our Lord and all these other fairy tales. All you kids out there, there's no Santa Claus and there's no God, and all these holidays are just a money-making scheme, that's all. Scam and a scheme. Because if they don't make it now, the rest of the year it's going to be. They're going to be, as they say during Christmas time, aftzoris. That's right. Going to be really, really bad. They're going to be aftzoris. We're all going to be out there on food stamps. Too bad they still don't have S&H Green Stamps, you know what?
You're right.
They do have a slot machine game called S&H Green Stamps at Hard Rock. It's kind of fun. Robert from Vancouver, Washington says, by the way, Vancouver, Panthers lost 5-3 last night. You won't find that score in either of your local newspapers because it was a late game, especially the Sun Sentinel, which goes to bed in 4 in the afternoon. I'm surprised the Sun Sentinel even knows the end of the football games. What a horrible, horrible piece of turd that paper's become. We sympathize with you, Tommy Jicka. He'll be out. He's been there for 100 years, but he'll be out. Everybody's getting canned for the holidays. Oh, here's the guy with the shoe again. They've only shown it 50 million times. Keep showing it. You can't show it too often.
Right, and he keeps missing.
Yeah. Yeah, practice makes perfect. Keep throwing him, and maybe one of these times it'll hit. But it won't make any difference because there's no sense, there's no feeling. Hello, Neil. I listened to your archives. Heard you want somebody who uses a Mac to email you. Well, you have some by now, but I'm going to send you this message anyway. I've been using Windows since 95. Got dissatisfied with Windows when I wanted to archive some old VHS tapes to DVD. I switched to Mac over 2 years ago. I've never regretted it. I've emailed lots of people, never had a problem. I've been listening to you since I had a radio accident and stumbled on your show in WNWS while you were ranting and raving about religion and reading from the Book of Ruth. That day changed my life forever. I'm just sorry I didn't tape some of your old shows, especially the ones on Zeta. Yeah, me too. I'd play them right now. I left Miami in the early 89, never regretted it. I remember when people would call your show and say they were leaving South Florida, you would get all apoplectic about it. I'm living out west and love it here. I'm just sorry I didn't leave sooner. While it does get pretty cold here, there's more to life than warm weather and blue skies. Amen to that. It's murky and, although it's 50 here this morning. What the hell's going on? The only thing I'll admit is that I miss about Miami is I've never had a good media noche tamale or lechon like I used to have on Cayo Ocho. I really miss that Cuban food. What's a lechon?
Pork. Roast pork.
Puerco?
Si.
That's me. Puerco. As for Chris getting kicked off the show, all I can think about is when people used to call your show wanting to get into the business, you'd advise them to find other types of employment. That's all I have for you, Neil. I hope you, George, and Chris have a happy holiday. Robert from Vancouver, Washington, man.
Thanks, Robert.
Thanks, Bobby.
The best talent.
Thank you, Rogers.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
Agarra la miel, Junior.
This is my wife. She wants gifts galore. Though my bank account's bare, these are my teens. Want what I can't afford. After New Year's, those bills, they're just unceasing. Christmas is here, not far away, and your efforts trying to budget are in vain. Make no mistake, on holidays you'll be overspending in so many ways. For heaven's sake, I gotta face shopping at the crowded mall. That's what I hate. With Christmas so near, I gotta say I'm putting everything on.
/11:32 at 560 WQM. Everything you've told me about this sales stiff, Andrew, is true and then some. What an idiot. What a bumbling, fumbling idiot.
Did we get it right the third time?
So we get another copy of the copy, and we got the header right and the dates.
Yeah.
But we still have the same misprints and the same. The grammar is like a five-year-old child would write. I don't want to read it because it's insulting, you know? It's just stupid. Just read through it and see the misspelling. G-R-I-O-L. Griol. Hey, let's go to the Griol and get a real three-o.
Right. Well, maybe they got something Creole.
That's it. Maybe that might be it. Or maybe they ought to put Andrew on the spit. Maybe they ought to nail him to the door next to the Christmas wreath. Right under the mezuzah. Here's one from Joe. If you're still entertaining ideas for Christmas bits, whatever that means, then I'd like to make a suggestion. You haven't played this particular bit in many years. May no longer have access to it. I think it even predates the George era. I never heard of it. It was a parody sung to the tune of Santa Claus is Coming to Town. I think it was called Santeria is Coming to Town. That ring any bells with you, Christmas or otherwise?
No.
The first one line went like this. You better not cry. You better not pout. You better not let your kitty cat out. Santeria is coming to town. There is nothing in that song the FCC can get their feathers ruffled about either, so I have no idea why you stopped playing it. A very well-written parody. Don't got it. Never heard of it. Don't got it. My God.
I have no idea why you stopped playing it.
We lost it. It slipped through the cracks. I never heard of it. Did you ever hear of it, Fatso?
Nope.
Uh-oh, the sirens are coming to get Joe. Here's one that says, with all the money and man hours the U.S. has wasted on the military training of the Iraqis, you mean they can't even hit a man who's standing still with a shoe? Mission not accomplished, says Greg in Melbourne.
Cute.
Yeah, suppose there would have been like a shoe bomb in there or something. Something evil. Maybe there were a bunch of like Iraqi cooties in there. Ooh. Here's Caesar, who also wants to add to the poll. The poll, by the way, is closed. The poll is closed. No more additions, no more anything to it. 678 votes. We're doing just fine for a horseball poll like this. And where's the one for tomorrow? Nothing to switch. Is Eric in his box or is he gone? Maybe Eric is too busy for us, too. Jesus, talk about he's feeling there. Neglected. What?
He's there.
So where's tomorrow's poll? Didn't he get it? If I hit it big in the lotto or a casino, I would blank. I would Schmidt. Tap him on the shoulder and say, hey, Eric, you tub, what's the story? That's awesome. All right. We'll leave this one on there for a while because we only got 681. What do you expect during the holidays, man? Your expectations are way too high. Nothing in the emails. Nothing. Zippity-doo-dah. They don't care enough to even send Chris their very best wishes. Because any day now could be... George wasn't expecting him in today.
Right. We were wondering.
Who's we?
Me and the turd in my pocket.
Oh. You and the turd? Neil and the bird, here's George and the turd. Don't be picking on Lucy Lopez like that. So, what's her name is coming, huh? Well, what's her name again? The sports bitch?
Anita Mann?
Anita Mark. Not the Anita Mann singers are coming, yeah. Then maybe they're going to do her jingles. Anita Mark is coming to a QAM. That's the rumor that we're starting today based on fake Jim Sarney's email. I don't believe it.
Eric says he got no poll.
It didn't go through?
Apparently.
Holy moly. But you know what? I'll do a new one. I emailed it to him. I know that. I mean, I faxed it. I did something with it. I shoved it. I stuck it in his direction. Caesar says, then what about those who moved here to be near a loved one, family, or friend, like those who meet people over the Internet and move here to paradise or come here for dying relatives? Unfortunately, I was born here. Have a great day. No more suggestions for the poll. Sorry, Caesar. The poll is closed. Okay? Let's work up a poll for Eric.
All right.
The pile that I've got is such swill. Even I won't put these on here. It's almost like footy, and where's the best burger in town for like 6 months in a row? No wonder you got your ass canned, footy. Jesus, God. Can't even come up with one good pull? We got to come up with a new one every day, and you leave that crap on. Where's the best chili chimangas in town, you know, for like 600 days?
Mm-hmm.
Crap. Poll. What's your take on the holiday season? Like that?
Okay.
The holiday season.
Sure.
Why? You say that sarcastically.
No, not at all.
Yeah, you are.
Okay.
I can tell. Has he got a look on his puss, Chris?
Always.
I love it. That's the first choice. I love it. I hate it. It's okay. I mean, how many choices can there be on this?
Okay.
I can't wait for it to be over. Isn't that the same as I hate it?
Mm.
I can't wait for it to end.
Okay.
There's four choices for you. And WTF. We stopped putting that on there. That reduced the numbers on the poll.
Okay.
We stopped putting it on there. So during the break, I'm going to fax that over to Eric, and then we can get rid of this other horrible one about how did you wind up in South Florida. And it's not even a poll. It's just a survey. There ought to be like 40,000 votes on there. 683, my ass. That's weak. No items in this view on the emails. They've abandoned me. I'm going to abandon them. I'm going to play these Christmas bits from now until next circus. Nothing in it. Neil at neilrogers.com. Here's my last call for emails. Isn't it almost impossible? Here's one that says, are Jewish people allowed to have Christmas trees in their homes for the holidays? Are they allowed? This is from that idiot redneck.
Oh, God.
That's already in the deleted folder. Real jackass. This is the one who said, do Jews celebrate Thanksgiving? Remember that redneck idiot?
Mm-hmm.
He's deleted. You're out, Scroggins. You're out. 688 on the poll. We'll change it as soon as we fax this new one to Eric. Then I'm going to play Christmas bits. We'll see. Maybe there'll be a whole bunch of emails in that thing in the Outlook Express.
Play some kibbles and bits.
So what's that one about Santeria?
Oh, I got it right here.
Oh, George hid it in a very cozy place. That's why we can't find it.
Go
biggest names.
Yeah, I'm looking
for it. This is Neil Rogers.
Rectum.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
The biggest names.
Best
the
talent.
Best talent.
It's the Mad Dog.
Jim Mandich. Afternoons 4 to 7.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
Neil God.
Eat a bagel, spin a dreidel, that's a Jewish staple. And they don't get to celebrate Christmas.
Oy.
We are laughing, they are crying, they get crap for 8 days. And nowhere on Christmas you'll hear.
At QAM. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do without Christmas. By the way, Paul Behrens, PJ Bear, whatever your name is, you're blocked under any name, so go away. Same chronic whiner. I don't read your crap. You're just deleted and blocked. Go away. Come up with a new fake name. Here's one about Randy Moeller, another wannabe play-by-play guy, another ex-jock. That's where it's come down to, man. Only ex-jocks. And let me tell you, Fatso, who really... Not that he's an ex-jock, but he really blows, and he's just there because of nepotism, and his brother blows, too. Greg Gumball. He is awful. He's got a really thin voice, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like he's not squeaking, but he can barely speak. Yeah, like that. Just like that. Just like the Jonas Brothers singing. Yeah. Like that. Thin. Greg Gumball. Strictly nepotism, and he strictly sucks. Okay, that's enough.
Okay.
You know who I mean, Chris? Greg Gumball?
Yep, of course.
Sucks. He blows. And he's not even an ex-jock. Where the hell are the days of the great sportscasters, huh?
I started laughing yesterday because I got home from doing the game here during just before halftime of the Steelers game.
Mm-hmm.
So I put the TV on, and they're going through, you know, it's now halftime. They're going through, like, you know, the highlights of the day. And, you know, Dan does his calls or whatever, and, you know, all the other guys. And then Sterling Sharp comes on, and I'm like, oh my God.
Sterling Sharp?
Shannon Sharp, whatever his name is.
Shannon Sharp.
Shannon comes on, and I was like, oh, wow, that's just bad. I just started, you know, remembering all the times that you, like, bag on him. I was like, wow, that's just bad.
He's not just bad in terms of listening to him. He's bad to look at. I don't know why the NAAPP don't get him his affa off the air. God, is he horrible. But, you know, another dumb ex-jock. That's what the American guys want to hear is dumb ex-jocks. And, boy, we sure got plenty of them on this station. Now, we got good ex-jocks on this station. We got dogs. Little dog, mad dog, big dog, small dog, round dog, square dog. And then we got...
rock solid.
That one, as John McCain would say. So he's on ESPN?
Apparently.
Like I've always told you, everybody and their brother's on ESPN. Like when the Booster confronted me at a hockey game one time in the old Miami Arena years ago and was sticking up for Chris, what was his name?
Moore?
Chris Moron, yeah. Oh, well, he's on ESPN. How bad can he be? And I said, everybody's on ESPN. What the hell does that prove? Because he's on ESPN, that makes him good. How, by the way, what team is he working for these days, Chris Moron? So anyway, getting back to LD, who says about Randy Moeller, listening to him last night was painful. A lot of general words, but no real description of what was going on. Really sad. I'd almost prefer Gildy squeaking. Not, it says. I'm a longtime Pats fan. They got something right a long time ago. Gil Santos is the radio play-by-play voice. Play-by-play down here is just embarrassing. Have a great day. You're absolutely correct, sir. Play-by-play in South Florida is a disgrace. From Joe Zagacki to Jimmy Syphilitic and right on down the line. Who does the Heat games on the radio? I know what Jerry Reed on TV who talks through his teeth. 77 to 72. Eric Reed. He could be really good if he'd stop with that affected, but he won't stop. He won't stop. He's pretty good except for the affectations. 79 to 78, 77 Sunset Trip. Oh, can't stand it. Who does the radio? You're listening. You're thinking.
Yeah, I'm looking it up, actually.
We don't know. You're looking it up. Well, that's what happens
Mike
when they
Inglis.
Take a... Who?
When Mike
they take a mensch like Dave Halberstam and they screw him over. Boy, that organization screwed him bad, Dave Halberstam. Remember that? Even
mm-hmm.
George remembers that.
I sure do.
I wonder if we're going to get any Hanukkah gifts from Dave Halberstam this year. He probably can't
probably.
Afford it either.
Hardaway left.
Left wing.
That's the one I meant.
Oh. Here's one of the better emails. They're not exactly pouring in to say the best. I'll just read them slow, you know. I'm just going to slow way down. Slow, slow, slow. No items in this view. Nothing. You people are a disgrace the way you abandon us. We got 703 votes on the poll. If Eric ever puts the new one up there, which he hasn't yet. Is he not getting my emails? Is that my faxes? Is that the problem?
He said he did.
He did get this one.
The said one new, about the new poll is ready.
Oh. No, it's not ready. Poll switch? No, it's got a number, but it doesn't have the poll names, and it's not ready to switch. Not ready to switch, okay, Eric? It's the holidays, man. Everybody's drinking too much freaking eggnog. That's the problem. Spiked.
Mm, sounds good.
Bunch of morons here last weekend. Not this past. Well, I'm sure there were plenty of morons tailgating yesterday, but minus 21 wind chill last weekend here, and they're outside hours before the game, before the Bills-Fish game. The Bills just suck. They're an embarrassment. If I owned the Bills, what's the guy's name that owns the Bills? Ralph Wilson? Is that
yeah,
it?
That's it.
If I was him, he's 140 years old. I would fold up the team and then kill myself.
Did you email or fax it to him?
I faxed it to him.
Okay.
What is wrong with you guys? I thought you're telling me on the one hand that he got it.
Yeah, no. What it is he set it up so that we could manually input one, but he didn't. Apparently, he said he didn't receive anything yet from him. I think. So I told him he...
I just got through faxing it to him, and it went through.
I just told him again.
Oh, this man is getting me really agita. Has he got it?
He's working on it now.
He's got it, then.
I'm in the middle of work.
Wait, what?
That's what he said. I'm working on it now. I'm in the middle of work.
Will you answer the question, you tub of lard? Has he got the new poll that I faxed him? Has he
yes,
got it?
I'm
then don't keep telling me, oh, he don't got anything. The audience will testify, okay? For the right price, they'll go on a witness stand right now and testify. You keep telling me, oh, he don't got anything yet.
I said, he says new poll
you
is ready.
You said crap
and
is
I
what
said,
you
he
said.
Said.
No
he
wonder they're firing your fat ass.
He said, I'm working on it now. I said, okay. He said, I'm in the middle of work. And then it says phones, customers, et cetera, get in the way.
Listen. Obviously, we respect the fact that his money-making takes great precedence over these stupid polls. We're not like pushing him, but just don't keep telling me he doesn't have it yet.
He didn't have it originally.
Here's one from Jose. He says, your show sucks, you dirty gay old man. I hear you every day. I love your show. George is another dirty, worthless radio personality. F you, sincerely, Jose. Thanks, Jose. Subject, you pig. That's us. And we're proud of it.
That's right.
So he's got the new poll, is what you're telling me, or doesn't he? You know what?
He now has the new winter poll, and he's working on it.
Yeah. What are we going to do without Fat Chris when he's gone? Who's going to be in contact with Eric? You can't do it all.
Guess I'm going to have to do my best.
We're going to be like stepchildren is what we're going to be.
That's right.
Stepchildren.
He says it's now up.
It is up?
Yeah, he already switched
it. Poll switch. Nothing to switch.
That's because it's already switched.
Oh, I see. Oh, it's already up there. He already switched it. Oh, I hate it. Now, I don't know whether to vote for I hate it or I can't wait for it to end. What would you say?
You hate it.
Okay, and look at that. It's okay. We got one. I hate it one, and I can't wait for it to end. Nobody loves it yet, and that's the people who love it, they're already out there shopping and schlepping. They don't have time for us in some stupid negatory pool on the birth of our Lord and all that other huzzerai. Yeah, during noon to two, I think we're just playing Christmas bits and Chinooka and whatever I can find. Because I made a great plea there on the emails, and all we got was, two or three, like this one. Chris, I love slot machines. I played Quick Hit Platinum Saturday night and started with $20. Got 15 free spins. Got more free spins twice. Won $84 on a $1.20 bet.
Woo!
That's on those 2 cent Quick Hit Platinum. I'm sure those high ones. I hate those. Don't play Deal or No Deal. It sucks. Fun to play, but you don't win Schmidt. By the way, Neil, do you ever play video poker? No, and if you do, I don't. Do you ever win? I don't win because I don't play it. And stay away from video roulette. Life of Luxury, good slot also. Life of Luxury? Love you, Uncle Neil. Sincerely, Chris. P.S. Who's got a bigger head, Keith Olbermann or Joe Rose? Nobody in the world's got a bigger head than Joe Rose. Although seeing Olbermann on the NFL shows yesterday, it's gone to his head. I'll tell you that. His head is swelling. He does a great job in his own show. I think we could live without him on the sports stuff. You think?
Sure, why not?
No, I mean, seriously, how many different things does a guy have to do? I mean, he's getting paid like $7 million a year or something like that, whatever he's getting paid. Millions of dollars. It's not the money. So what do we need to see him on there for, okay? God, Bob Costas, is he ever going to go away or what? Some of you people, just go away already. Don't go away mad. Just go away. Little Bob Costas. Somebody needs to step on him. Oh, here's Barry Jackass, finally. It looks to be the real deal. The internal email was leaked all over the country, and the person who did it is now looking for work. Well, we didn't get a copy of it. You know, your buddy Flea, I thought he was the insider. You know, I thought he knew his crap.
Yeah.
He's got no contacts. The people in the building tell me it's going to be, the people in the building, says fake Barry, that it's going to be Love 94, but one of them also mentioned the beast, the beat as the sacrificial lamb. What's the beat?
Don't know.
Again, 610 has to sacrifice its North Bay Village transmitter site, so the move to FM is probably a way to fix things. Oh, so that's actually going to go through. They're going to have to give up the transmitter site there that they've been getting sued for 100 years, and they're going to be like about 6 watts somewhere. They can be your low-power sports station to go along with James Crystal and his 48. So, I bet you, what's his name, is really excited about this.
What's his name?
Ray Perry.
Oh, yeah.
Because his dream came true, man. Oh, if we just had 100 more sports stations, it would bring a lot more people to talk sports radio. That's why they've all got shares. By the way, speaking of that, the trend coming out on Friday.
Right.
It's not the holidays. It's the trend coming on Friday. Lots and lots of pressure. Maybe that's why I was joicing and rejoicing so much this morning. A lot of stress and pressure, baby.
The best talent.
This is Neil Rogers.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The Sports.
The biggest names, the best talent. You're listening to Sports Radio 560 WQAM. Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
This is Brady Quinn. Whenever I shave my balls, I listen to the Neil Rogers 12 to 1 hour.
Language tape number 9. Learning how to speak whatever language Michael Jackson speaks. Listen and repeat. Michael Jackson. Repeat. Now it's your turn. Begin. No. Try again. Yes, very good. Let's continue. Michael Jackson. Repeat. Now it's your turn.
Oh, yeah.
Begin. If you're finding this one difficult, try grabbing your crotch. Much better. Let's continue. Michael Jackson. Repeat. Now it's your turn. Begin. Very good. Now, not only can you speak like Michael Jackson, you can also cough up hairballs. Now turn this tape over for language tape number 10. Speaking Little Richard.
Wah, bah, bloo, mah, blah, bam, boom.
I like that. Little Cute. Richard, how's she doing? Is she still preaching and whatever? Oh, there's that Blagojevich with a real bad hairpiece.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if he used the same doctor as Mo did on the toupee.
Doi, 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 doi.
37 votes on the new poll. We finally got it up there. Now go back and make some money, Eric, okay? We don't want to interfere, especially these days. Anybody who's got a chance to make a couple of nickels. 2 o'clock, guess where I'm going, speaking of making money.
Woodbine?
Good guess. So probably in the next 45 minutes, I'll start the process. I got my T-shirt and my shorts on now. Not my boxer shorts. I got those, too, but like my walking shorts.
You have lucky shorts?
No, I'm not going in my shorts to Woodbine in the middle of wintertime, okay?
No, like lucky underwear.
No.
Some people
lucky
do.
Lucky underwear?
Some people do.
It's plus 9. It's 48. It was 50 this morning, and now it's dropping down. Come on, let's get up to about 75 would be nice. Just for one day, for old time's sake. Wouldn't that be sweet?
Yeah.
50 degrees. Boy, we won't see 50 again until like March. So I better go outside and enjoy it. Let me go. I'll see you. 38 votes on the new poll. Our goal is whatever we get, right? What do we have on the first one? Our goal is a total of 1,000 between the first two. What did you
708.
Have on the first? 708. So we need 292. 708. Thanks. Brandon's got a poll. See, some people really care enough to send their very best. He's one of them. There aren't too many.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the people out there are slackers. That's right. Here's Brandon's poll. When I go on a road trip, I always bring somebody with me, pick up a hitchhiker, stop at Cracker Barrel, stop at rest areas, bring a load of CDs, talk to myself, sing, or just drive.
It's a good idea.
What about listen to the radio?
What about smoke dope?
Listen to the radio, smoke dope. Yeah, this is a good poll. It's got some good possibilities.
That's right.
Smoke dope, that's the part. George listens to the radio and smokes dope.
Well,
most of the radio you listen to in South Florida, you need to smoke dope. Okay, let's see what's their take on a holiday season. I can't wait for it to end, 12. It's okay, 11. I love it, 7. I hate it, 6. WTF, 2. I love it, 7. I hate it, 6. But I can't wait for it to end, 12. Yeah, and just, you know, enough already.
Right. I voted WTF.
WTF. That's a safe way to vote.
Sure.
That's not
there's no way
your
around
family,
it, you know. It's just
your family
something you
won't find out.
Right.
I sure hope that you're able to buy a whole bunch of Christmas gifts with all that money I sent you the last few weeks.
I always do, thanks to you.
You always do what?
That's where my birthday money goes. I buy presents for people with it. If
well,
not
you
for
sure
that,
as hell can't buy too
I'd
many
be the Grinch.
I sent you.
I do just fine. Thank you very much.
Maybe if I sent you a couple hundred grand, you could buy some nice gifts.
For myself.
What kind of a selfish answer was that?
I'd
you hear
my,
that, Fatso?
I'd buy
he
myself
buy
a shack in the middle of the woods and then disappear. Like
why
Ted
not?
Kaczynski.
That way you actually get what you want.
Right.
Ben says, you fat old fag, can't make up your mind, question mark. First you complain you're not getting any emails. Then you complain you're getting too many and rip the chronics. No, I'm not complaining about getting too many. Make up your mind. You're worse than a woman. What balance would you prefer? Happy holidays. Love the show, Ben. Ben's trying to be a ball buster, that's all. Happy holidays. How do you like that? Not Merry Christmas. See, Ben knows that I'm an old Jew, even though I don't celebrate no Hanukkah. I don't got no dreidel. I'm not giving away no Hanukkah gelt, although I already... I give away plenty of guilt. If I had in the bank right now all the money that I've given away to people in my lifetime, I could just get up and walk out of here and say, hey, screw you, Joe Bell.
You could retire.
Take your Jonas Brothers book and wipe your ass with it. And I like Joey. He's all right. But that concert, if they would just, you know, they do a lot of jumping up and down, running around the stage and all this other crap. Just do that. Don't sing. Or don't do whatever that...
They could do what Milli Vanilli did, you know, and have somebody sing for them.
That's right. Have somebody who can sing and write real music, write it and sing it.
Sure.
Because those kids, boy, they are just awful. Awful. Horrible. Now, here's speaking of bad crap. Catalonia's fecal Christmas activities. You sent this to me on Friday. I don't know.
Okay. I mean, it came over the facts, you know.
Yeah, somebody faxed it to us, which means it's extra hard to read. I can do it, though. Some of the world's most curious Christmas traditions can be found in Catalonia, where the idea of holiday cheer seems to involve some of life's more basic bodily functions. Here are two something that one wouldn't necessarily expect to find on the same Wikipedia entry. I can't read this. It's two actoids? Factoids. Oh, the F is missing. Two factoids. The infant Jesus is God in human form, and everyone defecates. You think the infant Jesus defecated? Holy Schmidt.
It would have been.
Maybe that's where that expression came from.
Now that you mention it.
Oh, holy Schmidt. I like it. But if you never if you navigate to the entry, see, this was a bad copy on the fax. Is that how you got it?
Yes.
If you navigate to the entry attempting an explanation of the fecal-centric Catalonian tradition known as El Carañer.
What?
El Carañer.
Okay.
El Cagamoon. That's exactly what you'll find. Indeed, the tradition is a much-loved element of the Christmas celebration in Catalonia, despite its somewhat obscure beginnings. A caganier, or pooper. Oh, I wonder if Anderson Pooper is in Catalonia. Is a small figurine of a person squatting down with lowered pants or raised skirt to answer nature's call. They've been around since the 17th century and can often be found hiding in an obscure corner of the nativity scene. Oh, no, the caganier is hiding in the corner. I wonder if he's bending down, if he's squatting. What a Schmitty nativity scene that would be. Some say that the figurines originally became popular among farmers who believed, quite practically, that the caganier's offerings would make soil rich and productive for the coming year. In somewhat vaguer terms, the website for the Association of Friends of the Caganier, an organization founded in 1990 to celebrate the caganier tradition and which boasts 60 members spread across the world, states that the figures are meant to add a human side to the representation of the mystery of Christmas. Oh, is there a mystery of Christmas? What's the mystery?
I don't know.
How Mary got knocked up?
Yeah, who's the baby daddy? She's going to go on Maury.
The Wikipedia entry mentions how the caganier might represent the equality of all people because everyone defecates, or it may be meant to reinforce that the infant Jesus is God in human form. So even Jesus occasionally had a bout of wild, bloody diarrhea like Joe Bell. Young children in Catalonia still play a Where's Waldo's-like game that involves searching for the caganier in the nativity scene arrangement. According to the Friends website, the caganier is placed under a bridge, behind a haystack, or otherwise discreetly hidden, as it would show a lack of respect to have him near the arrangement's manger scene. The original El Caganier is a wooden or clay figure of a peasant. This is a bad copy. Clay figure of a peasant working the traditional floppy red Catalan cap with a black beard and smoking a cigarette or pipe. But the figure's popularity has led to a massive expansion in the range of defecating figurines. Oh, just what I want for the mantelpiece is a couple of defecating figurines. Mark Alos is part of a family that's been producing and selling such figurines since 1992 in Girona, a town 62 miles northeast of Barcelona. The company, Terra One Mar, Caganier.com, which offers 150 types of Caganier figurines, ranging from political and sports figures to more anonymous and traditional figures, such as farmers, nuns, and Santa Claus. Oh, I can't imagine Santa Claus taking a big dump. I sure hope he pulls those red panties all the way down. All of them evacuating their bowels. People call from all over the world asking for us to make statues of their local figures, Allo says, but there's no way we could make everybody happy. With annual sales of between 20 and 25,000 figurines, Allo's company is the largest of its kind. By far the most popular figure, Allo says, is the traditional farmer figure. Second place, however, is occupied by a squatting version of outgoing U.S. President George W. Bush. All right. The squatting W. When asked why he thought Bush's figure was so popular, Ilos preferred only to say, "We always sell most to the people who are either loved or hated." Based on recent sales figures, Ilos adds, it would appear that U.S. President Obama fits into one of those categories as well. The other scatological element of the traditional Catalan Christmas is the Tio de Nadal, which roughly translates as Christmas log. Oh, I wonder if the Catalan, whatever his name is, I wonder if he drops a little Christmas log.
Well, you've heard of the Yule log.
Yes. Also known as the cagatillo, or pooping log. This character is a 1 foot long, hollowed out on one end. Hollowed out. It says hallowed, but
maybe
I
it
think
is.
I mean hollowed. Oh, yeah, it's hallowed. It's Christmas. In recent times, the other end of the log has been giving a smiling face, topped with a miniature version of the baratina and propped up on two stick legs. What's baratina?
I don't know.
Starting on December 8th, which marks the Feast of the Immaculate Conception holiday in the Catholic tradition, the log is fed small amounts of candles, nuts, figs, or torrons, a local type of nougat, every night and sleeps under a little blanket. On Christmas Eve or Christmas Day, depending on the household, one end of the log is put into the fireplace in order to poop. To hasten and encourage the long symbolic bowel movement, children sing special songs and beat it with sticks, yelling, "Cagatio!" Someone then reaches around the log under the blanket to bring forth a gift that is then shared by the group. Oh, one can only imagine. Of course, if the revelers are still hungry, then they can always go back to the local pastry shops, which have sweets shaped like feces on offer during the holiday season. Oh, my God. Sweets shaped like feces. Holy sweet Schmidt.
What do you think a Tootsie Roll is?
Oh, exactly.
Or a Baby Ruth. Sometimes even a Butterfinger.
You know something? Butterfingers. I was thinking about that yesterday.
I love Butterfingers.
I don't see that. Not only do I love them, I'm obsessed with them, and I never have seen one here. Anywhere.
Really?
No. As you know, they got all kinds of really neat, you know, crunchy and all these other candy bars, Smarties, all this stuff, but no Butterfinger. I would kill for a Butterfinger right now.
Biggest names.
The best talent.
This is Neil Rogers.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
The biggest names.
The best talent.
It's the DA Show.
Weeknights from 8 to 11.
Here on
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
Oh, God.
Was the night before Christmas. The whole house was mellow. Not a creature was stirring. Because I had my gun under the pillow. Went up on the roof. I heard something pound. I sprung to the window and yelled, "Yo, keep it down!" When what to my wandering eyes should appear but the dawn of all elves and 8 friggin' reindeer. With a slap to the snouts and a yank on the manes, he cursed and he shouted and he called them by name.
Yo, Tony. Yo, Frankie. Yo, Joey. Yo, Vito. Hey, Paulie. Hey, Vinny. Hey, Rocco. Hey, Guido.
With slicked back black hair and a red silk suit, Don Christopher was here, and he brought the loot. As I drew out my gun and hid by the bed, he flew through the window and slapped me upside the head.
What the hell are you doing pulling a gun on the Don? Now all you're getting is coal, you friggin' moron.
Then pointing a finger right up my nose, he twisted his pinky ring, and up the chimney he rose. Then I heard him yell out what I least expected.
Merry friggin' Christmas to all, and you better show some respect.
Come on, boys, let's go home.
12:18 at 560 WQAM, happy Monday to December 15, only 10 days before Christmas, only 6 days before Chanukah, and almost to 2009. Maybe we'll have to bring Robert Grieper back, so, you know, we could say 2009. What do you think?
Well, he could say some other days, too, and then we'll...
No, let's not. Oh, guess what movie was on last night? No, I did not watch 60 Minutes. And you want to know why? Because I was channel surfing and I found Christine was on again last night for the 4. I was thinking, as many times as The Godfather was on, I think Christine is like maybe a distant second in terms of movies they keep showing over and over and can't show it too much for me. I like it.
Okay.
And not just because John Stockwell is in it and lying almost naked in the bed there in the hospital with a broken leg. No, I like it in general. It's a good movie. You like it?
It's fine.
What about you, Chris? You seen Christine?
A while ago, yeah, it's fine.
You don't sound too enthused about it. I've got a celebrity death, by the way, while you guys are thinking about your altitude about Christine.
Okay.
Van Johnson dies at 92.
Oh, no.
Now, you know, the one, I didn't like Van Johnson at all. I hate to say that now that he croaked. You don't like anybody. Well, I sure didn't like him. He was boring. But the one movie he was in where he was pretty good, you know what it was? Caine Mutiny.
Yeah.
I mean, he was only in about 8 million movies.
Right.
Van Johnson, whose Boy Next Door wholesomeness made him a popular Hollywood star in the 40s and 50s, with such films as 30 Seconds Over Tokyo, A Guy Named Joe, and The Caine Mutiny, died Friday of natural causes. He was 92. Johnson died at the Tappan Zee Manor, an assisted living center in Nyack, New York, said Wendy Blywise, a close friend. He died of natural causes. Why? 92, old age. Always cracks me up when somebody 92 dies. Oh, well, what do they die from? Old age.
Right.
With his tall, athletic build, handsome, freckled face, and sunny personality, the red-haired Johnson starred opposite Esther Williams, June Allison, Elizabeth Taylor, and others during his 2 decades under contract to MGM. He proved to be a versatile actor, equally at home with comedies like The Bride Goes Wild, Too Young to Kiss, war movies, Go for Broke, Command Decision, musicals, Thrill of Romance, Brigadoon, and dramas, State of the Union, and Madame Curie. During the height of his popularity, Johnson was cast most as the all-American boy. He played a real-life flyer who lost a leg in a crash after the bombing of Japan in 30 Seconds Over Tokyo. He was a writer in love with a wealthy American girl, Liz Taylor, in The Last Time I Saw Paris. He appeared as a post-Civil War farmer in The Romance of Rosie Ridge. More recently, he had a small role in 1985 as a movie actor in Woody Allen's The Purple Rose of Cairo. Didn't see it, but if it's Woody Allen, I'm sure I ain't going to like it.
It was actually all right.
Was it?
Oh, I mean, recently, man. That thing's like in the 80s or something.
23, it says 1885.
Okay.
1785. A heartthrob with Bobby Soxers, he was called the non-singing Sinatra. He married only once. In 1947, at the height of his career, he eloped to Juarez, Mexico, to marry Eve Wynn, who had divorced Johnson's good friend Keenan Wynn 4 hours before. Oh, boy. Woo! She divorced Keenan Wynn, and then 4 hours later, she eloped with this goofball off to Mexico, to Juarez. The marriage produced a daughter, Skylar, and ended bitterly 13 years later. She wiped me out in the ugliest divorce in Hollywood history, Johnson told reporters. She wiped him out. She got all the loot. As a young actor, he had a brief run with Warner Brothers. Then got a screen test and a contract with MGM with the help of his friend Lucille Ball. Lucy! Lucy! After a bit of the war against Mrs. Hadley, Johnson paired with Lionel Barrymore as Dr. Gillespie's new assistant, as Mickey Rooney's friend in the human comedy, and as a Navy pilot in Pilot Number 5. His big friend with Irene Dunne and Spencer Tracy in the wartime fantasy A Guy Named Joe was almost wiped out by tragedy. On April 1, 1948, his DeSoto convertible was struck head-on by another car. They tell me I was almost decapitated, but never lost consciousness, he remembered. I spent 4 months in the hospital after they sewed me up on the back of my head. I still have a disc bone on my forehead 5 inches long, he says. In the 60s, he returned to the theater playing Damn Yankees in summer theaters at $7,500 a week, even more than a fat boy's getting. $7,500 a week.
That's probably nice.
George is getting the 75 part.
Right.
Then he accepted a 2-year contract to star in The Music Man in London. For 3 decades, he was one of the busiest stars in regional and dinner theaters, traveling throughout the country from his New York base. In 1980s, he appeared on Broadway in La Cage aux Folles, late in the run in popular Jerry Herman musical. Late in the run. Born Charles Vandell Johnson, August 25th, 1960, in Newport, Rhode Island. Ba-da-beep, ba-da-boop, ba-da-bop. He tried his luck in New York. He arrived in 1934 with $5 and his belongings packed in a straw suitcase. Boy, what a story, huh? And now, he's dead. 92.
Oh, well.
Well, 92 is plenty old enough, isn't it?
Sure, I'll take it.
Oh, me too. That'll give me 27 more years, and I'll be on the air every second of it, by the way. I'm not going to retire. No, I'm going to stay on just to piss off those people, especially the people in the business. Oh, he's lost it. He's fading. The numbers will be out on Friday, and I don't think they're going to be really good. But that's okay. These people don't care, meaning the Beasleys, Joe Bell, he don't care about. He cares about a good number, which is maybe, well, what's her name's coming back. What's her name again?
Anita Joint.
Anita Joint, yeah. 88 votes on the poll. What's your take on a holiday season? What do we have on the first one? 7-1? 707?
708.
Oh, 708. But 707 would be better. Eric Reed would like that. Larry Kent used to do that, too, and now he's dead. Big, fat, and now he's dead. He used to go to Mary's on 120, whatever the hell it was, 135th and 441 there. Thereabouts. I loved Mary's. They had some of the best pizza ever. And he'd get a whole large pie and just, with a fork, eat the topping. Not eat the crust, you know?
Right.
You think that's a good idea?
I think it's a great idea.
It's a good Atkins way. It's no carb.
Sure.
Big pizza. He weighed about 9,000 pounds, Larry. And now he's dead. Been dead a long time. Fat. Van Johnson wasn't fat, though, I don't think. I don't know what he was 92. I remember Winston Churchill. How old was he when he died, by the way, Winston Churchill? Look that up. He drank a gallon of booze every day and smoked about 20 big stogies.
Right.
And he lived to like a ripe old age. He was fat. He was like the W.C. Fields of politics. The Dow is down only 31 points. Not bad. I'll take it. When I say I don't really care, but I mean, just for those people out there, the poor bastards who are losing their ass. What's your take on the holiday season? I can't wait for it to end 30. It's okay, 26. I love it, 18. I hate it, 14. And WTF, what the 6? Winston Churchill, how old was he?
90. November 1874 to January 65.
When was he born?
November 1874.
26.
January 1965, so 64. So, yeah, 90.
90 years old. Goes to show you, all you kids out there drink a lot of booze and smoke a lot of big fat ones and maybe some stogies, too.
Biggest
names.
The best
talent. This is
Neil Rogers.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
Biggest
names.
The best talent.
The Big O.
Orlando Alzagary. Morning Spot to 7.
Sports Solid.
560 QAM.
The sports leader. Holy cow. Aaron's coming.
Bomb, 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 bomb their ass. Bomb, 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 bomb their ass.
Down only 34 points, not too bad. And Sirius is hanging right in there at 14 cents.
Oh!
All right. It's hanging. There is a Blagojevich. They keep showing him with that pasty hair, you know?
Mm-hmm.
He looks just like Stan Major. He really does.
Really?
That's the way Stan looked about 100 years ago, yeah. Mike in Hollywood says, been a big fan for years. I'm reading these. I'm stumbling and bumbling. That way I'll have to read them twice, kill more time. Because there's nothing in the email.
No worries.
What do you mean by that?
Just do what you do.
What does that mean?
Just make sounds with your mouth.
We need like the Jonas Brothers.
That's right. Whimpering. I think you could do a little better.
Oh, my God. I'm embarrassed. I'm humiliated and degraded. I mean, at least the Backstreet Boys and some of those boy bands, at least they made some, you know, stuff that could be passed off as music.
Correct.
Some of it pretty good. But these kids just...
That's good.
I'm telling you.
You missed
your calling. I'm right now. Anyway, here's Mike and Holly. Well, let's get off the Jonas Brothers, okay? Let's get off of Joe. Been a big fan for years. I drive for a living, so I listen to you every day. I just wanted to tell you I've been married 20 years with almost two full-grown kids. I've never had the desire to be with another man before, but if you buy me a 2009 Corvette, I'll let you be my first. No, you're obviously much too old for this old queen. You don't mind a little spanking first, do you? Also, if George is jealous, I'll allow him to watch if you don't mind. This is Mike in Hollywood.
Wow.
Oh, Mike. See what I mean?
Delusional.
They got no material. They have nothing. They're reaching and they're stretching. Well, it's the holidays. Matt in Miami, who loves the callers. We haven't had any yet today. Let me look. Oh, I don't see any on there now. I mean, if you think the emails are going to be sparse, who the hell's got time to call? They're busy. They're really busy, man.
See.
Matt says, how was your weekend? It was a busy. I hope it was a good one. Did you watch 60 Minutes last night? No, I was watching Christine with John Stockwell. It was really good, except for the blonde bitch that was doing the interview. That couldn't be Leslie Stahl, could it? That bitch.
Who else?
Well, I wish you nothing but the best. I have to go now, says Matt in Miami. He has to go now. Like the Moody Blues. If you think those two were weak, wait till you're this one. No, you might like it. Keith says, do you know what was in the briefcase in Pulp Fiction? Keith?
No. No one knows. You're not supposed to know. You're supposed to use your imagination.
Oh, but it was the guy's soul. It was his soul.
Yeah. It's
one of the worst movies in the history of the subhuman race. Pulp Fiction, my ass.
I'll start pulping.
God. Let's get some of that mayonnaise for the fries, okay? Oh, Jesus, God. Goes to show you can peddle any kind of crap to the public. WQAM, hello. First call of the day, and they're gone. QAM, hello.
Hey. Hello?
Hello.
Great. So this thing ain't working.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh.
Are you serious? The phone thing ain't working?
Maybe not. Let's start diddling with it. See what happens.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I might have control in here. Chris might have
QAM,
control in there.
Hello.
But guess what? We got them both on.
Hello? They can't hear me.
Yeah, I have the pod on.
QAM. QAM, hello.
Hello?
Hello? Oh, it's Stan. Stan Major.
Will.
Yeah.
What's up?
Can you hear me?
I have nothing to say.
Oh. Maybe they can hear me. They just have nothing to say.
That could be.
QAM, hello.
Happy holidays, Neil, from the boy.
Oh, it's from the
have
schmuck.
Great.
Yeah. Yeah, goodbye. QAM, hello.
The worms have been bleeding.
QAM, hello. Hola.
Hola.
Oh, see, they can hear me.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Neil.
Yeah, what do you got?
This is a fan.
Mm-hmm.
I am not a girl in Louisiana, dude.
I don't care what you are. You're annoying.
Well, just tell the truth, man. You can't handle it.
Pardon? I don't care what difference does it make who you are. You're a chronic. You're just a pest.
Okay, that's your opinion, man.
No, it's not my opinion. It's a fact.
Listen. All you do is knock down the fans that call you and disagree with you.
Disagree with me? You're not disagreeing with me about anything. All you're doing is just being a chronic pest. That's all. You got nothing to say.
That's not true. I got
plenty
of things.
Okay, let's hear what you got. Let's hear what you got.
Don't agree with it, buddy.
Let's hear what you've got. Let's hear what you've got. Ah, that's what he's got. Nothing. A fan. A-hole is what it is. Like a typo, I guess. A-hole. Hang up with people who disagree. Did he have an opinion on anything?
No.
No. Is that pathetic or what?
Yeah.
And if he can't get through on the emails, he's going to call on the phone now.
Right.
But he's a fan, who's an expert on my life, by the way, and everything about me and about you and about the world in general.
Right.
He has no life.
I have no life.
If we had a dime for every one of these people,
yeah,
it says that all you do this and then you give them the chance to say whatever the F
they have nothing
they want,
to say.
They
That's
can't.
Right.
They choke.
What do you
nothing.
Got? And then he just starts screaming. Oh, you disagree. Everybody's there. Right. And I would have left him on there as long as he wanted if he had something to say, and all he gave me was a dial tone. Schmuck. QAM, hello.
Hello?
Yes?
I'd like to wish everybody at 560 at QAM 0560 a holiday to remember from the great one and the Reverend Jones.
QAM, hello.
Yeah, Neil.
Yes.
Remember.
QAM, hello. Oh, I like the sound of that dial tone, though. QAM, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yep.
The callers that call you are either nervous or they just have nothing, absolutely nothing to say. So that's the deal. That's the deal with that.
Yeah.
Neil?
Yes. Yes. No. QAM, hello. Hola. Oh, it's the slurper.
No, that was me.
No, that part was you, but the beginning was the slits, the mad slurper.
I see.
QAM, hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Yeah, I wanted to call and let you know about Matt Castle.
Oh, yeah. We don't want to hear about you. We don't want to hear anything about you, quarter schlock guy, okay? Die Inu. Not because you disagree, because we never discussed anything of any anything to disagree with or agree. You're just an a-hole. That's all. Just like a fan. Oh, no, you're wrong. That's your opinion. No, it's a fact. Anybody who just can't sit back and listen without knowing that they're just annoying and chronic, just get lost. That's all. If you want to listen, fine. If not, go away, a fan. Go away. What is this? Raw story. Oh, yeah, but it's on our thing. Okay, go away. Jose, can you please tell my friend Troy the Bills are a piece of donkey turd and tell Annalise that she is the brain of a pea? Thanks for making my mornings longer and full of torture, Jose. See, we got the same two or three people. That's because they're the only ones who care enough to send anything. But not the people who have been blocked, like a fan. Oh, if anybody disagrees with you, that's why you've been listening for 100 years, right? Because I'm a mean-spirited bastard and won't discuss anything with anybody who's got anything to say. Of that run of calls we just had, who had anything to say?
Nobody.
Hey, you want to see if one more caller has something to say?
Who's that?
I don't know. Just
anyway, we're testing the phones here.
QAM, hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi.
I just want to let you know I'm on my way to Saturday.
You what? What did he say? I couldn't hear anything he said.
Try something again.
Oh, QAM experiment call. Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
Is this Neil Rogers show?
Yes.
I would like to say hello to you.
Yeah, your phone sounds like you got it in your earlobe.
I got the speaker on. I'll take the speaker off.
Yes, please.
Oh, God.
Hello?
How's that, better?
Much better.
Okay.
Yeah. What do you got?
Where is Neil?
Right here. You're talking to him. Schmuck.
I just want to say hello to Neil. I want to thank him for...
Well, let me ask you again. Why are you talking to me in the third person when I keep telling you you're talking to Neil, okay? Why do you keep talking in the third person?
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
I finally found someone who agrees with me about Pulp Fiction. I thought the movie sucked.
Yes, you're right. Okay. See, there was somebody who agreed with me. I still hung up on him.
You see how you are?
That's right. I'm just disagreeable, man. That's me.
Biggest names.
The best. Well, I'm a fan. Why can't you say I'm a biggest fan?
The fourth leader.
The biggest names, the best talent. It's the big dog, Joe Rose. Weekday morning, 7 to 10. Sports Radio 560 QAM, the sports leader.
Enough of the talking.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. This here is the king. I know I haven't been around much for a while, but I want y'all to know that up here in rock and roll heaven, I'll be thinking of you this Christmas. And I'd like to give y'all a special Christmas message. A message of peace. Like, how about a little piece of that pie going by? Thank you. Thank you very much. Like I was saying, Christmas is a time of hope, a time of joy, a time for loving. And I sure would love a big slice of that pizza you got there. Okay. Thank you very much. No worry about that. Oh, yeah, Christmas. Now, Christmas to me means family. And family means friends. And friends means getting together. And getting together means eating. I'll pass me that drumstick, would you please? Well, thank you. Thank you very much. And I just want to say to you right now, you know, I may be a big star, maybe too big, but ain't nobody so big you can't reach out a helping hand. A helping hand. Would you hand me a helping of those mashed potatoes over there, would you please? Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, like I was saying, ain't nobody so big he can't stoop to help a friend in need over the holiday season. Now, speaking of season, you want to pass me that salt shaker when you get the chance? Thank you. Yeah, just unscrew the cover, that's right. Thank you. Thank you very much. So this Christmas, why don't y'all take a tip from old Aeolus? Now, I'll leave those steak tips right where they are, you know what I mean? No, I appreciate it. Thank you. I want you to remember, we're all part of God's great big family. And you know God made man unto his own image. And look in the mirror, I'd have to say God must be a big, big son of a gun. You know what I mean? I think you do. But I especially want y'all to remember this one last thing. When you're all at home this Christmas, stringing that popcorn up on the tree, save a big, big bowl for the king. Extra butter, you know what I mean? I think you do. Thank you. Thank you very much.
1247 at QAM. That was a real festival of great call there that we just had.
Sure was.
Now, they're all going to sound like that from now on? I'm talking
about
the content.
Well, we would like to do some more experiments.
That's what we've got to try and find out.
Oh, we'll take another bunch of calls here. We're experimenting.
Yes.
Because they've got the new hookup here so that they can bowl Chris out.
And we're not done tweaking it either, so.
Now, that's obvious because the technical quality of those calls. Of course, the substance was sensational, especially my close personal friend, a fan. You can always tell a fan when they start screaming and hollering. Oh, and anybody who disagrees with you, you go blah, 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 and click. Just go away. That's all I ever asked on the emails. That's all I ask in life. Go away, okay? You live your life. I'll live mine. It'll be just fine. It's a radio show. Oh, you're right. I have no right to tell you. And then, like, the next day, he'd come back again with the same swill all over again. Obviously, a demented soul.
I have no life.
With no life.
I have no life.
567-0560, #560 on the Verizon AT&T wireless line. We're checking out the new phone hookup so they can blow Chris out and save a few bucks on his show. How many bucks?
About 30, man.
About 30 bucks a week. WQAM, hello.
Hi, Neil. Ted Bell.
QAM, hello. QAM. How's the experiment going so far?
Pretty good.
Q, QAM, hello.
Yeah, I'm calling for Neil.
Speaking.
How you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Did you read the papers about Bush almost a shoot at in Iraq? While he was visiting over there?
Yeah, Abe Lincoln got a bad headache, too, okay?
It wasn't from Maliki's hand, man.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Why are you doing this to me?
I hate you and I don't want to torture you.
I'm going to start putting my Woodbine clothes on here in the next break. This is an act of incivility is what it is. Hostility. Oh, well, we got to test out the phone. Okay.
That's right.
QAM, hello. Hola.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey. That's funny. The guy before me brought up the same thing. I thought it was humorous to see Bush dodging shoes. He actually has.
Yeah, they've only shown it about 6,000 times, right?
Yeah, he has pretty good reflexes. I have to give him that. But I called Cephalo this morning because he was talking about it, and I pointed out that if they actually investigated this guy and all the things that we think he's done and probably has, a shoe would be nothing to what he deserves.
I'm sure Mrs. Syphilis didn't like that.
No, he hated it. He thought I was a crackpot, but believe me, I mean, if the guy did...
I don't think you're a crackpot. I just think you're a chronic caller. He called Jimmy Syphilis this morning and now calls me to repeat the same crap. Mm. I don't care about the shoes. I don't care about W. He's only got a few days left, and goodbye to him. Coma-inducing, ponderous. But we're doing a technical experiment here on air. Right? How long does this experiment go? Till 2?
Yes. No, I don't know. See, that feedback and stuff that we're getting, we don't know if that's just... Cause sometimes you get that just anyway, but we don't
QAM,
know if it's a matter of this.
Hello?
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 Let me try it again. Goodbye. QAM, hello.
Neil, can we get rid of George and...
WQAM, hello.
Eating sleeping worm.
QAM, hola.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey, I heard you a little bit about
Go out and buy a phone, okay, and then call us back. Buy a real phone instead of the Campbell soup cans. WQAM, hello. Now, what was that?
Three.
No, that was astonishing, but it just vanished all by itself.
Right.
Yeah. WQAM, hello. Hola.
Hello?
Yes.
Yes. That briefcase in Pulp Fiction, they got that from a movie called Repo Man, that when they open up a trunk of a car, the same light shines.
Mm-hmm. No, but there was aliens in the trunk.
Alien was in the trunk. Alien. Let me ask you something. It must be the phone being all screwed up because...
Yes.
I was thinking it was the callers, but it's not.
It's the phones.
It sounds like the wind is...
That is what we have determined.
That must be really good with our great signal. What?
That's what we've determined so far, is that there still needs to be some tweaking.
Tweaking? Talk about an understatement. Tweaking my ass needs to be an H-bomb in that piece of equipment, whatever. Every call starts out like that. And I'm thinking it's like bad phone technique or something, or like they got their phone in there.
Rectum.
Which a lot of them it might just as well be. But no, it's like QAM noise. But I tell you, the engineering department, great job in this case. Great job. Unbeatable. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
I was wondering, when are you going to come down and do your golf stream appearance this winter?
This winter?
Well, it's winter.
I'm not.
You're going to stay up in Canada and freeze your kahunis on?
Yeah. I'm not freezing. I'm nice and toasty in here.
So why aren't you going to come down and do the golf stream appearance?
Maybe I'll do it next summer. I don't know.
Did you read Jicka's column Sunday about Calder?
No.
They canceled their last two stakes races because of the poor economy.
Mm-hmm.
How lame is that?
Lame.
Very lame.
Yeah.
Well, I hope to see you when you come down.
Okay, great. Well, hold your breath, okay? We'll let you know. Obviously, this guy...
I have no life.
...is waiting. He's got... When are you coming down? You're going to stay up there or freeze your ass up? I'll do whatever the hell I want to do. How do you like that? And the phones are the same, just like we've always said, same as the emails. Tell me how to live my life, when to go here, where to do there, how I call, disagree with anybody who disagrees with me, I hang up on them, yada, yada, yada. A-Fan my ass. I think A-Fan and the jerk who's supposedly in the Philippines, what's his name? Not Nick Nolte. I think that's same person. Gotta be. There can't possibly be two people so tragically obsessed. Obsessed. Oh, I'll go away now. I'm going to go live my life in the Philippines with my beautiful girlfriend. Okay, great. And every now and then you look at the deleted stuff. There he is again. Same as this jackass. On and on. One thing to listen to a show and enjoy it or hate it or whatever you feel about it. But it's another thing that's your life, you know?
I have no life.
It's not even my life, and I do the show. If this show was my life, I'd blow my brains out. Good God. So there's all kinds of feedback inside the phone line, it's all screwed up.
Right.
WQAM, hello.
How's it going in Canada? Huh? How's the weather?
WQAM, hello.
Good morning, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Just wanted to tell you, man, you are truly the Grinch.
Mm-hmm.
You are, man. I saw that movie the other day, dude, and for some reason I just couldn't get you out of my mind, man. I'm like,
yeah, I know why you can't get me out of my mind, but that's another story.
Out of your mind?
Out of your mind.
You said yours.
No, I said you're out of your mind. WQAM, hello. QAM. Breathing line. WQAM, hello. Hola.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Boy, that rang right through. It didn't even ring or anything like that.
Well, what do you mean by that?
You just picked me up cold.
No, I'll be damned.
So, two things. One, I'd rather have the harness races, you broadcasting those again, than get these stupid callers. Mine inclusive.
Mm-hmm.
Get the free tickets for Pompano for me.
Wow. You know who that is? That's not Nick Nolte. That's who that is.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Guaranteed. Do you know anybody else in the audience who cares about harness racing?
No.
Oh, here's one. It says, I'm laughing over here. A fake fan. Thanks, you old bastard. Fake fan. Well, good. I'm a funny old bastard. As opposed to dirty old bastard. Let's get dirty on the phone.
Dirty, we call him.
155 votes. What's your take on a holiday season? Now, what do we have in the first one? We're not going to get anywhere near 1,000. Are we?
Yeah, no. We can. We had 708.
So we got 863. We need 137 to get to no chance. No shot. Well, we're up against it now. Damn old Santa Claus. What's your take on a holiday season? It's okay, 47. I can't wait for it to end 46. I love it, 35. I hate it, 18. WTF, what the F, 12.
The biggest name.
The best talent.
Oh, I got to do a spot. Oops. See, there you go. I faked you out again, Tubby.
Oh, well.
Probably thought I was going to, screw it up, didn't you?
Yeah, of course I did.
Well, I was thinking about Andrew, the sales guy, you know? George just can't control himself going on and on about what a putz this guy is.
Right.
The biggest names, the best talent. You're listening to Sports Radio 560 WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Hello, this is Arnold. This is not a tumor. It's the 1 to 2 hour.
Deck the malls with cards of credit. La, 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 la. Tis the season to get indebted. La, 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 la. At the mall with my friend Daryl. La, 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 la. Parking put our lives in peril. La, 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 la. Mile long lines and frowning faces. La, 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 la. Greet us both with verbal disgraces. La, 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 la. Christmas shopping, sure, no pleasure. I must resort to drastic measures.
Hey, get out of the way, kid. I need the Roboraptor.
Push the kid and cuss the cashier. Fa la 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 la. After this, I'll need a cold beer. Fa la 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 la.
Sing your carols all you want, you little brats. Doesn't make this any happier for me. Yeah, 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 yeah.
my age. All of a sudden, Christmas is 19% revolving credit and 6 months to pay it off. Hey, you, I saw that first. Hey, give it back right now before I shove my boot as far up your lala as it'll go. Yeah, ho, ho, ho to you, too. Hey, miss, how can that possibly be out of stock? Don't you people realize there's more than one customer who might want to buy it on special? Where's the manager?
I'm the manager. You got a problem?
I only wish the happiest of holidays to you and yours, sir. Kids, come here, come here, come here. Help me sing, okay? Yeah. La, 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 la. I got to get out of here. Merry Christmas. Yeah. It's going to be a long drive home.
103 at 560 WQM. Happy Monday. Boy, it's almost over. Thank God.
Damn God.
Oh, my goodness. You and this phone experiment of yours, it sucks.
Phone experiment of mine?
Yeah, yours. WQAM, hello. QAM. WQAM, hello.
The following announcement is a QAM phone test. Joyce blows, Joe knows, George like hoes, nail the homo. The preceding message is only a test.
How do you like it so far?
Sounds great. Let's do more.
No. Let's not. Well, what's it going to accomplish? Well,
you can stop any time. We already told Steph it's not working.
Yeah. Hey, Steph, it don't work. It sucks. It blows. So I guess this means that Fat Chris is going to be hanging on a few more days.
All right. At least a couple.
Yeah, till they get it fixed, okay? Till they get the ficus fixed. Because this sucks. In fact, I take back what I said to that one guy. And get the tin can and a string. Two tin cans and a string, you could make better a radio than this. Good God. This is a radio station with a phone system that's a piece of turd. Oh, but we got ways to cut back. We got to cut back budget cuts. Yeah, why don't we just eliminate the phone? I can live without it.
And the transmitter.
That's right. And the transmitter. That sure cost a hell of a lot. And the tower. And the rent on the building.
Right.
And the equipment.
Think of how much money we can save.
That's right. Budget cuts so we can get Anita Marks down here. So Joe can sit there and get all whipped up to a frenzy. Oh, it's Anita. Oh, Anita, you're such a great... You know what it reminds me of? It's like the Aaron Summers experiment at IOD. Same concept. Oh, she's got a great ass.
Holy cow.
I don't know if she'll do a good show or she's going to be any good on the air, get any numbers, but she's got a great ass.
Holy cow.
That was Steve. I don't give a nickel about him. That was his justification for putting her on the air. That show sucked. WQAM, hello.
Yeah, how's it going?
Okay.
It's Adam from Kitchener-Waterloo.
I beg your pardon?
It's Adam from Kitchener-Waterloo.
Oh, well, you get a life already.
I'm in Hollywood. How's it going?
What are you doing in Hollywood?
I got a place down here.
Oh, well, then what the hell do you do here in the wintertime?
Go to the beach.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm back at school in Waterloo, so.
Yeah.
I just wanted to say hi and apologies for being...
Chronic. Chronic. No, don't apologize for being ugly. You can't help that. But apologize for being chronic.
But, all right, fine. Sorry.
No buts. Right. No buts.
All right. Love you.
See ya. Oh. I feel like I'm being stalked 24/7. The stalker.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe the next call will be from the walker. I wonder if he ever croaked.
Or the Alta Cocker.
Oh, well, you can be sure of that. Oh, yeah. Well, we haven't heard from him in a long time. The nasty old. The Dow's down 105, by the way. And Sirius is hanging in there 14 cents.
Oh!
All right. Katie says, I'm interested in harness racing, but I'm smart enough to know it's a terminally boring subject to most. All the way with Bucky Day. All right, Bucky Day at Rockingham. Alfred Bucky Day. He was good. Green Silks. Cashed a lot of tickets on Bucky Day. Let's talk harness racing. Come on. WQAM, hello.
Hi, Ron. Come on. We're here. Always here. La, 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 la. Hi, Ron. Okay?
QAM, hello.
Hello, Uncle Ponderous.
Yeah.
Do you ever have a Bukkake?
QAM, hello. QAM.
Neil.
Yeah.
I don't think you have any materials. The show has no materials, and that's why the engine calls today. You know, there's a reason for the show.
Yeah.
So, that's all I got to say.
What do you got?
That's what I got for you.
There we go. WQAM, hello.
Neil, how are you?
Okay.
Neil, why is it, I haven't had your show for a while, but I heard a critical meeting, they keep breaking the chemistry up from your show. It's the same thing with Josh, and every time you get a good nucleus, they want to break it up, because they know that people listen to you, but...
Budget cuts, baby, budget cuts.
It's unbelievable.
Cold cuts and budget cuts.
That you have about a new car, they told me.
I beg your pardon?
Is it true that you bought a new car?
You know, I can't even understand what these people are saying. This phone is so bad.
Is it true that you bought a new car?
No, I, the level is low, and I can't understand a damn thing what they're saying. 181 votes on the poll. If this is what the phones are going to be, this is just another reason not to take any calls, in spite of your insistence.
Hey.
Hey, my ass.
I'll go get the pitchfork.
Well, no, you just got through telling me that...
you don't have to.
What do you mean by that?
Take any calls anymore.
But I wanna.
All right, well, then go.
Go what? I already did go many
times.
You
go, girl.
Hurricane Geo says, not sure if you saw it or heard it only a million times. Howard Stern to leave SiriusXM. Who cares already, okay? I'm so sick and tired of his PR machine. Oh, Howard picked his nose, and Howard farted real bad, and Howard's wife's got diarrhea, and Howard. Good. Get a life. WQAM, hello.
Hi, Fling the Pill and Calorie Hot Wings, please.
QAM, hello.
I'm Jack.
Hi, we're here.
QAM, hello.
Benefits. We will never compete with you. It's our loyalty to our member attorneys that sets
now, how come
us
she
apart.
Sounds so good?
Loyalty that can only
we
continue
just did something
when
different.
You run.
You did or not?
We did.
What did you do?
I turned my pot off and gave control back to Chris in there.
You know, the original way.
Yeah, and it works just fine.
Right.
So in other words, whatever they set up in there, it's screwed up.
Right, it's not
it's
set up
right. It's a
piece
of turd.
Right.
It's a big, smelly, nasty. I've got my pants on and my shirt. And during the break, I'm going to put on my shoes. WQAM, hello.
Oh, Neil. Oh, Neil.
Yeah.
Oh, Neil.
Oh, no.
Oh, Neil.
QAM, hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Hey, I've got a movie recommendation for you that I think you would definitely like. Have you seen that movie called The Lookout?
No, never heard of it.
You would definitely like it. It's an intelligent movie. I think the young man in the movie might be someone to look out for. But also another thing, that bit, that was by Jim Schuyler, that Santeria Christmas.
Never heard of it.
Santeria's coming into town. Well, I think it's by Jim Schuyler back about 20 years ago.
Okay, I'll dig around.
I think he's thinking about cafeteria.
Okay, also another thing. Hello?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay. I was the one that called you about that, the Jonas Brothers, when you were talking about music.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. You said that you didn't remember it. You might want to check with the Alzheimer's, local Alzheimer's, not the be rude or anything, but it seems like you're the... The dime's slipping a little.
No, I don't think so.
All right, maybe not. But all right, well,
But thanks for the critique, though, of my life. That's good.
Yeah.
No
that's
call
all.
Is good. No caller email is good without a critique of my life and my brain and my whatever. Yeah, the Don is slipping. Do you remember him calling about the Jonas Brothers?
Nope.
Well, I think he must be slipping, too. I think we're all slipping.
Totally slipping.
Slipping away with Clarence Carter. God. You're slipping. You're old. You're this. You're feeble. Check the Alzheimer's people. Don't you remember my call? My call? My email? Dow is down 128 points. Not good. Not real bad. Oh, look at this. Here's one. It says, your shtick is so old. Terry from Batavia. You just keep embarrassing yourself. Retire already. No thanks. No thanks. I got a better idea. Turn it off, Terry, and go back to Batavia. Oh, look at this. Suggestions for emailers to the Neil Rogers Show. From Cliff and Kendall. A long list. Hey, Cliff, find a hobby, okay? Wow. Heard you this morning, but don't know if you lost me or whatever. Sounds like you wanted to use it, but hear it again. No, I don't want to use it. I put it on there, but the poll is so bad, I don't want to use it, okay? Sorry. Happy holidays. If I win it, hit it big in a lottery casino. It's boring. Oh, my God. Now, Jose, because I blocked Jose, now he became Sammy. Sammy. Even the emailers are crazy.
Clover? They're the same people. What do you mean, even the emails?
Same people.
Right.
Larry says that SNH green stamp machine takes too long to build up points. They have a new Monopoly game in King Kong. At least these machines give plenty of free spins and money, says Larry. Here, let's talk about the slots, okay? Maybe the quarter slot guy will call back, but we can only pray not. And you notice now that we opened the phone, what do we have today? We had, hi, Ron. We had that pair of misfits, of mental midgets. We had the boyfriend and the reverend, and then we had the quarter slot guy. Oh, no, Neil, you're wrong. The callers are wonderful. They make the show. 191 votes on the poll. What do we need? Besides
292.
We got what?
We need 292.
You're a crazy person.
To get 1,000, we need
899. We need 101 votes for 1,000.
Well, yeah, total. I was doing what we needed for this total poll today.
For what?
To hit 1,000. We needed 292 on the current poll.
So we need 101.
Correct.
Can you handle this?
Actually, we need 98 now.
Well, there you go. There's a Bush and Blagojevich hand in glass. In fact, he just brought him his shoes back.
Biggest names.
The I don't know what, Blago.
This is Neil Rogers.
Sports Radio 562 AM.
The sports leader.
The biggest names. The best talent. It's the Mad Dog. Jim Mandich. Jim Mandich. Sports Radio 560 QAM, the sports leader.
Neil God.
The critics agree this collection of holiday songs may very well be the most moving and memorable of all time.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.
Yes, Candle Wax Music presents Elmer Fudd's Christmas Classics. And this 24-record set is truly incredible.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Oh, what fun you'll have hearing these timeless classics performed by America's most beloved hunter of wabbits.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it was.
Elmer Fudd's Christmas Classics, not available in stores. And when you receive your set in the mail, you'll know why.
Hello, everybody. I sure hope you like my Christmas classics.
So call toll-free 1-800-FUDD. Operators are standing by.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
119 at 560 WQ. I mean, I'm thinking back to Cliff from Kendall, who's a regular, and his list of instructions for what people should do when they send the emails.
Okay.
That would be like making a list of things people ought to do when they call a talk show, especially this one.
Yeah.
As if. As if.
Well, you should write such a list.
Well-intended, Cliff, but a little naive. Oh, yeah, right. Well-intended. And Terry from Batavia, by the way, is also, you know, you made a good point back when we started the emails.
Yeah.
And I think except for the birthday, the gigantic rash of emails we had then, except for that, 95% of all the other stuff that comes in is like the same, oh, 8 or 10 people.
Right. And
right?
I believe that it's a lot of those people are people that you have banned whose voice you recognize, you know, who'll make up a generic name.
Oh, maybe. This guy, a fan that called before. I mean, you could knock me over with a feather duster, the fact that this guy can't control himself. And his whole shtick is, bah, bah, you know, toward me. And yet, oh, I love the show, and I've been listening for a million years, blah, 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 and I'm so sorry for being, and then, bah, bah, you know. There are a lot of unbalanced people out there. If he doesn't like anything I do on a show, go away. I don't need life instructions from any of you people.
I'm going to keep going back to that restaurant and ordering that food I don't like.
And then this Terry, the references to Batavia, again, it's the same thing with the harness racing. This is not Nick Nolte, who's the same as a fan. And like you said, they're like maybe one person doing like about 20 different shticklach.
Right, right.
Which is pretty sad commentary, by the way.
It is.
Michael says, I'm not a chronic, but I've listened to you since the days of four-quarter habitat, Grand Union grocery stores, New England Oyster House, Lums, and so on. You say the people in Toronto are friendlier than down here in Miami, and I can believe that. Although I remember a friendlier and civilized Miami back in the 60s and 70s, it was a simpler time. I'll soon to be retired from the MDPD. What is that?
Miami Beach Police Department?
Oh, it said MD. Maybe it's a typo. Oh. I've seen it all. I'll have to move to a location to enjoy the change of seasons. Not as cold as Toronto. A slower place to life. Maybe some mountains and some nicer people. Yeah, you can move in with George in North Carolina.
Sure. Lots of room.
My son and I met you several years ago when you, Rick, and Suds were doing an appearance in Sunnyland, where Pinecrest is now. You signed the autograph card, Get Cereal. Suds signed his card, Don't Be a Butthead. My son died in a car accident earlier this year, and like me, he did listen to you as well. Your show is great, and I do listen when time permits. George does yeoman's work when you're away. Take care. Thanks, Mike, and very sorry to hear about your son. 212 votes. You know, they made a big deal. Well, I'm not saying they shouldn't. I mean, didn't Dan Marino's dad just pass away here a couple weeks ago?
Mm-hmm. A week ago.
And, and our great quarterback on the Patriots, his dad just died a few days ago, too. But nevertheless, I'm thinking to myself, other people's dads die, too, you know, not just famous people. I'm not talking about Danny Boy or Matt Cassel, but nevertheless. You know what I'm saying?
What are you saying?
I don't know. WQAM, hello.
I'm your friend. I'm always here for you. And I'm sick, and I got the flu, and I got laryngitis. And I watched
You know who that is? That's the bitch. That's the sweat hog.
Uh-huh. Fat, greasy, nasty,
greasy, dripping, hairy, scummy, slimy piece of turd crawled out from underneath the dumpsters one day.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, who else would confabulate with those two? And then she shows up with the retarded one. I'm your friend. She shows up with him at the Gulfstream appearance. Oh, I hope you don't hate us. Yeah, we do hate you like poison. And we wish horrible, evil things would happen to all of you. We wish that maggots would come pouring out of the ceiling and infest every pore of your body, although I think they beat us to it. Well, there's the shoes again on CNN. How many thousand times have they shown that today? 30,000 times. And I think I've seen about half of it. Insulting the president. Well, nothing anybody could do or say would be insulting to him. Enough. So I think what we've done is we've narrowed it down to like a very precious few on the emails and also, you know, like all the radio ones are like one or two people.
Yeah.
The fake Barry Jackass and the fake Alice Rantel and the fake Greg Budell. All radio people with no life.
I have no life.
And probably pretty soon with no job. WQAM, hello.
It's me, Prozac Ron.
QAM, hello. WQAM, hello.
I'm constipated. Happy Hanukkah. Oi!
Now, there's another guy who thinks that he's most amusing.
Mm-hmm.
The singer.
Yeah, Opera Man.
Is that him, the Opera Man?
That's what I've been calling him. It'd be great if you come up with some new material.
Does he call you too?
It's always about it's always about constipation. I said, you know, come up with some new songs and, you know.
Well, maybe he's got a constipated mind. 212 votes on the poll. We got 708 and 212 is 920. Need 80 votes in 36 minutes. No chance. Wasn't our goal like 950?
I think that's, I think so, yes.
Pretty sure that's what we said. 950. WQAM, hello.
Yeah, when's the big switch in Iowa and love?
QAM, hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
Hey, did you see on World News last week what the latest gift is for Christmas that people are doing?
No.
They have in the malls now tattoo parlors. I mean, remember the day the only people that got tattoos were sociopaths, misfits, and losers, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And it's the dumbing down of America as far as I'm concerned. People can't verbalize what they have to say, like down here. So they have to paint themselves, and that's the only way they can express themselves.
Gross. That's the only word I can think of to describe it as gross, especially people that have got, like, covered with tattoos.
Oh, yeah. I don't know when George was born, but anybody after 1965, they're very limited vocabulary. I don't know what it was. Maybe they stopped delivering papers twice a day back around then.
No, we don't have no papers no more.
Yeah, no, it's ridiculous. All right, Neil, stay in touch, all right?
I'll see you at the parlor.
Bye-bye.
Not tattoo, massage parlor.
Oh.
216 on the poll. What are we going for? We're going for whatever we get.
Yep.
And I'm telling you, this was a good test, though, and it seems to me that you've straightened the problem out.
Yeah, because we're back to the original way.
That means we got to keep Chris.
All right.
WQAM, hello.
I'm throwing my shoes up.
QAM, hello. Oh, speaking of shoes, he must be psychic. I got my shoes on. Yes, sir.
Mr. Neil.
Yes.
Hi, Belly.
WQAM, hello.
Neil, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
There are some normal callers. I just call to wish you and George and everybody that works there a happy and a healthy new year. No religious overtones, even though you're a Jew and I'm a Jew and George is a Jew and George gets high too much, but happy new year.
Okay, Zagazun. Let me ask you something. Why don't they wait for the reply? You know what I mean? In other words,
no fun.
It isn't?
No.
Why can't they wait for like a response, like Cox Ahoy's, like that? Something.
Biggest name.
Anything.
The best talent. This is Neil Rogers. Sports Radio 5.
That's right. That would be a conversation. Sorry.
Sports leader.
The biggest name.
The best talent.
It's the DA Show.
Weeknights from 8 to 11.
Here on
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
Heard of Rudolph and his shiny nose, and we all know Frosty, who's made out of snow. But all of those stories seem kind of gay, 'cause we all know who brightens up our holiday.
Gay.
Mr. Hanky, the Christmas poo, small and brown, he comes from you. Sit on the toilet, here he comes, squeezing tween your festive buns. A present from down below, spreading joy with a howdy ho. He's seen the love inside of you, 'cause he's a piece of poo. Sometimes he's nutty, sometimes he's corny, he can be brown or greenish brown. But if you eat fiber on Christmas Eve, he might come to your town. Mr. Hanky, the Christmas poo, he loves me, I love you, therefore vicariously he loves you.
I can make him Mr. Hanky too.
Sometimes he hangs off the end of your ass and won't fall in the toilet, 'cause he's just clinging to your sphincter, and he won't drop off, and so you shake your ass around, try to get it to drop in the toilet, and finally it does.
Mr. Hanky, the Christmas poo, when Christmas leaves, he must leave too. Brush him down, but he's never gone. His smell and his spirit leave.
.133 at 560 WQM. The big O at 2.
Rock solid.
Sociopaths, misfits. That's what we get mostly all the time. And
there
especially around the holidays, as opposed to, you know, people who are like sending a little bit of love, you know?
It's a second chance at love. It's another chance at love.
Now, have you seen that show or not?
You're asking me?
I'm praying that I never have to be exposed to that show again.
We talked
another
about
shot
it.
At love.
I gave it a shot for 5 minutes. And
yeah,
it's,
I gave it a shot.
I was hoping for something, and I didn't see it, and I moved right along.
It's Terry in Batavia, and your show is old and boring. Retire! Retire!
Hey, Terry, who's also another half-dozen other misfits. Like I told you, I did predict this in the beginning, when there's total anonymity, like the emails,
mm-hmm.
as opposed to the calls. The calls, we know the voices. Within 2 seconds, you know who it is. The singer who thinks he's very funny, who ought to be ashamed of himself, who's an idiot, and the other half dozen. And now we got a fan calling, a fan, a.k.a. Not Nick Nolte, a.k.a. Terry from Batavia, a.k.a. Whatever else, Misfit.
Mm-hmm.
Larry says, now Larry's a very emotional guy. Long email. Wish there was no Christmas or Hanukkah outside of houses of worship. They become anything but religious observances. Granted, Hanukkah never was. The worst aspect of this time of the year is on the kids, really. If you celebrate Christmas, then the kids whine about needing this toy or that Xbox, etc. And if the parents can't afford it or find it, then somehow they failed as parents. It makes kids believe in Santa Claus. If Santa was real, then who should their parents kill, sometimes literally, to buy some toy the kid will ignore an hour after unwrapping it? Parents don't make any effort in dispelling this belief. If the holiday is about goodwill among men and peace and all of that, then I'd like to, I'd like one of the keep Christmas, I can't read it. It's chopped off. Keep Christian Christmas honkers to explain to my 9-year-old who is Jewish and struggles every year with why he doesn't get a Christmas tree or Christmas presents, why his classmates make fun of him for not celebrating Christmas and celebrating Hanukkah. At his school, one door is covered with Christmas decorations, one door is covered with Hanukkah ones, and of course, as a result, one kid's got labeled one door the Christian door, the other the Jewish door. And of course, Jim Lowe's got one labeled as the green door. If you're Jewish, then you can't go out the Christian door, etc. The teacher did nothing about the thing I mentioned to her. I can't read the last part. It's chopped off. Someday you'll help me with that chopped off thing.
Well, experiment with it.
My son said he went through any door he felt like. I thought this was because he wouldn't do what this other kid said, like most of the classmates, and thought this was good. But it turned out he went through the Christian door because he didn't want to feel different. Is that the spirit of the holidays? Yes, Larry, it is. It's a goyish belt. 47 years ago when I was 3, a friend of my mother's put me in line for a Santa Claus at the old Howard Johnson's in 12 Corners, this in Rochester, no less. Probably right by Earl's Drugs, where I used to buy my baseball cards and where I used to get my haircut at whatever the haircut place was. Apparently, the mistaken belief that my mother wouldn't care. Apparently, I caused quite a ruckus and caused the rest of the kids in line to cry and the mothers to get mad at me and my mother. When it was my turn to talk to Santa, I yelled, "I don't believe in Santa Claus, you're not real." I never had that problem that my son experiences every year. Christmas, if it is possible, is so pervasive in a negative way with all the commercials and Black Friday concerns and holiday specials and songs on the radio, much more than when I was his age. And what's made it worse, that my wife, who used to celebrate Christmas as a kid, wants to do it again with a tree and all. Now I find myself trying to help my son feel better about himself and not doing Christmas without my wife's help, since she'd get lost in her own melancholy and nostalgia. I'll be quite happy when this festive holiday season is over and done with. Amen, Larry. Get with it, Chew Boy. Oh, brother. Got to put a stocking on the fireplace. I don't have a fireplace, so I got no place to hang my stocking.
Just maybe you could by the window.
Hang there. Santa instead. Or just hang some of the chronics. By the way, I noticed that the Outlook Express is dead. Done. Finished. No emails. Isn't that something?
Yep.
After we finally discovered there's about 6 people sending all the emails, I guess those 6 people got like, oh, geez, well, I don't know what they got. Hopefully syphilis or something good like that. Okay, well, since we got such a really good start on the calls, now that we got the phone system all straightened out again. See, we can't do the show without Chris. If they could find a way to do it, they would just automate it. That's how cheap they are. You
right,
know?
All of us.
Even the Dutchmen aren't this cheap, and that's saying a lot.
Well, that's what we do at nights.
What?
Automation.
On ESPN?
Yep.
There's nobody running the board?
Look at the schedule.
And what if the signal drops out?
Oh, well.
Yeah, too bad.
WQAM, hello.
I believe in Santa.
QAM, hello.
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 Hey, Neil.
Yes.
Listen, man, tell that dude Larry to get his kid a dreidel and move to Bar Harbor, and he won't have any problems.
Cox-a-hoist, Schmendrick, Schmeckel, anti-Semite, bigoted bastard, etc. But happy holidays to you, though. See what I mean about goodwill on and peace on earth and all this? Oh, here's one from the fake Josh Cordes. If George would give up his 3% raise in 2009, WQM would not need to kick fat Chris off the show. Selfish effing bastard. Hi, Brandon, says Josh. The fake Josh Cordes. How do you like that?
Mm-hmm.
You thought that's your friend, Josh, and he's calling you a selfish bastard.
What do you know?
If the FCC under Obama lets up, will Beasley do the same? Well, what's Obama going to do about it? He's not going to make the FCC let up. No politician is going to be for smut, you know? When does greed kick in? The funnier you are, the more money they make, no? Here's looking to a more hilarious new year. Thanks, Neil, you old SOB. Oh, these people are just, they're hysterical. Don't knock yourselves out, okay? We got lots and lots of calls coming in. There aren't any good ones, but we have lots of calls. We don't need these bad emails. I never dreamed I'd see the day when the calls were like better than the emails. Bad. Weak.
Names.
The bad.
This is Neil Rogers.
Sports Radio 560 QAM.
The sports leader.
The best names. The best talent. It's the Big O. Orlando Alzugari. Afternoons 2 to 4. Sports Radio 560 QAM. The sports leader.
I want to bang you in the butt, honey.
And now, another edition of What If? Today, what if Janis Joplin were an Avon lady?
Just a minute. Yes, may I help you?
Next time to find out what would happen if Nancy Reagan lost weight.
This bulletin just in. It appears that the First Lady has disappeared.
When next we ask, what if?
Ow! I got my shoes on, maybe my shoes, my shirt, my pantaloons. I got it all on. I'm all ready to go.
Yeah.
I'll get in that, hop in that vet at 2 o'clock and zoom out. And get away from these wonderful, friendly people. Boy, you talk about the holiday spirit in reverse. Nasty. Hostile, nasty, these folks, you know what?
Yep.
It's the South Florida thing. Oh, but you're freezing your ass off up there in Toronto. That's right, and you know something, and I'm enjoying every second of it. Hear the sirens?
Yeah.
Nope.
Sirens are coming for anybody who thinks that going to the warm weather will make you happy. Miserable, hostile, unhappy people who want to share their misery with you. That's what South Florida is all about.
Well, at least they're sharing.
Yeah, that's right. They're sharing for the holiday season and all the rest of the year, too. They're sharing That's what they share. No charge. 5670560, pound 560 on the Verizon AT&T wireless line. Emails have just dried right up. Since we outed those five people who sent all the emails, it's the same 10 people, guaranteed. And by the way, Tubby, we wanted 950. You got it. 708 and 251 is what? 959. We did it, and with a big push earlier, we made that time. 962. How do you like that? If we'd really pushed it earlier, but you know what? We don't care. We don't really care, do we? No.
Well, we about QAM. The
hello.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that air reporter guy who's throwing those two shoes at Bush, whatever.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That was stupid. He should have used a freaking bomb instead. I know we got plenty of them in Iraq. Should have. Or at least an AK-47. I know we got plenty of those over there. Just boop. Just should have shot him and killed him. Freaking two shoes.
Okay, I dumped that because the last thing
I was wondering why you left him on as long as you did.
Well, because I knew that I'd eventually get, you know, we got an 80-second delay. Because he's dumb, that's why. I mean, not that I disagree with the premise of what he said. He's just dumb. 5670560. If there anybody out there with an IQ larger than their shoe size.
No.
Huh? I think my shoe size, when I come right down to it, is
nine.
For those people with no lives who are writing a book about my life. Oh, Neil, you'd be so much happier if you did this and you did that. Blah, 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 blah. That was actually funny, the fact that Nick Nolte and A. Fan and Terry from Batavia all were here together at the same time in the same body. And just absolutely upset with me. Oh, you're right. But they won't go away. Just go away, that's all. Have a wonderful life, although I don't think you will, but just go away. WQAM, hello.
Hey, how you doing, Pally?
Okay.
The reason why he threw those shoes at President Bush was because of the two souls left there that believed in democracy.
QAM, hello.
Where's my present?
WQAM, hello. Nothing like people trying to intellectualize some, you know, act of hostility.
Yeah, yeah.
The guy was sending a message. That's the... That's what they say is the most hostile thing you can do. Oh, now what is this? Dear Neil, did you happen to see over the weekend where one of the folks who got taken by Bernard what? Madoff's Ponzi scheme. Do you know anything about that? Was none other than Norman Brayman. Maybe Mr. Brayman should have been paying more attention to what was in his stock portfolio than the Marlins' efforts to get the ballpark. I'm all for Norman Brayman, sorry. Wasting time, especially we're in a freaking depression, and we need a ballpark for the Marlins that nobody cares about? Anybody go to the Marlins?
No.
Anybody going to the Heat this season?
No.
No. How about the Panthers? Any interest there?
No.
They won a whole bunch of games here lately.
No.
No. Let's build a whole bunch more stadiums, okay? Keep knocking Norman Brayman. But nevertheless, that's the kind of crap we get. Pure, unadulterated crapola. WQAM, hello.
I need a cab.
You need a help. You need real help. QAM, hello.
Yeah, we feel your pain.
Yeah, feel this. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Listen, man, aren't you guys always saying that, you know, you get pissed at people when they try to change your station or try to change your show, and you tell them, you know, if you don't like it, you know, don't listen to it.
That is correct, yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so how come everybody's, you know, all bent out of shape about Christmas, man? You don't like it. You don't want to celebrate it. Guess what, man? Don't get a Christmas tree. You know, don't watch the Charlie Brown special, you know, all that good stuff.
I see a little bit of difference, okay? You got a whole bunch of radio stations and music and stuff you can listen to. Christmas is shoved in our face, and you know that.
Well, it is.
It's bastards like you, inconsiderate, insensitive bastards, brainwashed bastards like you, who shove Christmas in everybody's face, whether
we
want it or not.
I celebrate it with my family. I don't push it on.
Well, great. Okay, then stay inside, and we'll let you know when you can go out.
You're an asshole, man.
Oh, see that? How do you like that?
I thought that's one of your friends.
Yeah, he wants to be my friend. I'm your friend. You're the a-hole, man. You're the real serious. Oh, Barry McCockner, the real one, says, I'm the sixth person. Okay, Barry. Now, Barry actually usually is pretty good. You know, Barry McCockner?
Mm-hmm.
Let me say it again. Quit proselytizing. Quit using religion as an excuse to beat people over the head with it. That's right.
What? That's what it's all about.
I'm going to come after you with a menorah if you don't watch it, okay? Kanahora, let's go get him with a menorah. WQAM, hello.
Santa is real.
QAM, hello.
Very controversial shit today, Neil.
QAM, hello.
Neil.
Hola.
I'm a black man, and I tell you...
Yeah, sure you are. QAM, hello.
I said, have a nice day.
Yeah.
It's him again.
Very controversial show. Hello? Hello? Neil, can you hear me? Like to go ahead and get a message to the boyfriend of
Vegas. QAM, hello.
Neil.
Yes.
Oh, the cigar store, a few stores up on 71st and Collins, always has the show on every time I go in there.
Really?
Yeah, they have a lot of good stuff there. Good photography, good cigars, and they're
good.
Friendly people.
Good for them. Oh, you're talking about, what's his name, Captain Singh?
Yeah, they're very nice people there.
Yes.
Have a good day, Neil.
Okay. Woo! Oh, my God. Oh, my effing God. Well, at least he wasn't hostile anyway.
Yeah, you better celebrate our Christmas or we're going to stick your Jew ass in an oven again. And blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, right. Not that we're trying to force it down your throat or anything like that. There was nothing like going to assembly when I was in high school and having the Lord's Prayer. And everybody had to, like, you know, lower their head and in Jesus' name. And I'm thinking, why am I mumbling in Jesus' name? You
yeah,
know?
Well, that's what you get for killing Jesus.
That Yoshki, he ain't nothing to me, you know? That Yoshki.
Yeah.
268. Boy, we did a number here today. It came on strong at the end. 708 and 268 is 976. Oh, brother. To come so close and fall so far short.
What?
I don't know.
We'll blame it on the phone problems.
Shofar, yeah. Shofar, sure. Yeah, the phone. Thanks to both of these guys for inspiring me to take 100. Did we have any, like, real call? Like, anybody who had anything to say today? One?
No.
One? How about
no.
A fan? You don't count him?
No.
He was, like, really psychotic. Oh, and you don't know anybody disagrees with you. You hang up on blah, 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 and I have no life. No
this
kidding.
I have no life.
Rogers.
Sports Radio
560 QAM.
The sports lead.
The biggest names. The best talent. It's the big dog, Joe Rose.
Weekday morning, 7 to 10.
Where South Florida sports
always matters.
Always matters.
Sports Radio 560 QAM. The sports leader.
It's day in Miami town.
Yes.
At 560. WQAM.
Everything is the celebration.
You fairy.
Jesus was born, and so I get presents. Thank you, Jesus, for being born. Born on your name. And as you hear the angels sending.
QAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.